All right, welcome to another edition of IEPY CSGO. This time we are in playoffs. IEPY will be taking on Michigan State Varsity in the round of 16 of FACEIT Collegiate Spring 2023. Both teams come in with positive records. Michigan State on the lower end of this equation ended the season 5-3. IEPY, on the other hand, ended 6-2. Both teams share a loss to Davenport, and IEPY's other loss is, or I should say was, Arizona State. Michigan State's other two losses were Virginia and RIT D1, I believe. RIT has two teams. Yep, it was RIT D1. Michigan State was able to take a map in that affair, but did lose the series. And additionally, their match against Virginia, I believe that was actually a 2-0. Yeah, indeed, Virginia was able to 2-0 Michigan State to end the season 6-2. So a common factor between both of these teams is that all of their losses, IEPY's two losses and Michigan State's three losses, were all sustained against playoff quality teams. I say playoff quality because Davenport had to forfeit the season, so therefore they did not make the playoffs, obviously. The assumption there is that at worst, Davenport would have taken the loss that they had to, I think it was Drexel, and they probably would have finished out the season undefeated. Maybe Northwood could have etched in another loss there, but at worst, Davenport was going to make playoffs. And the same could be said about Arizona State, who was a playoff team. I believe they ended the season 5-3 and would have just snuck in like that 13-16 seed range, but they had I think they had some kind of academic or like transcript issue, because despite their playoff qualification within the FACEIT Collegiate standings, they did not make the 16-team bracket. And I can actually show real fast on the FACEIT standings page while we still have the time that Arizona State and Davenport, both of these teams are teams that IEPY and Michigan lost to, Davenport being both teams and ASU just being IEPY. Both of these teams are not in the final 16 playoff brackets, but you could also identify Virginia and RIT D1. So both of these teams have very quality win-loss records coming into playoffs. There is no bad loss for either of these teams. As far as momentum goes, however, the Jaguars are winning that battle. IEPY closed out the season on their new starting lineup the best they could. There was a sub for CMX in the last game. But this five-man lineup, or the core of the four players, are 2-0 moving in to playoffs after the loss to ASU, with technically two standings at this point. And Michigan State, on the other hand, was 5-1 and lost their last two matches to RIT and Virginia. So the momentum is currently on the side of IEPY. Michigan State looking to turn around their losses into wins when it actually matters. And as far as the stakes for this game go, both of these teams are playing for their share of $500. So each player will walk away with $100 after winning this match. Winning this match also moves them into the round of eight, where there can be more prize money won. Now, that being said, moving on does mean for both of these teams playing against the two seed and Northwood. Northwood would be heavily favored in both of those matchups for sure, but the attempt is only allotted the team that wins. So a lot more stakes in this match than in any other match. And speaking of stakes, IEPY has basically been playing pseudo playoff matches ever since they lost to ASU because of their relatively low Bukul score amongst the crowd. They would have likely ended up at such a low seed that any early round playoff match was going to be very difficult, if not impossible, depending on where they ended up. Michigan State, on the other hand, has not played a true pressure match the entire regular season because of their 5-1 record moving into this match. They were pretty comfortably sitting in playoffs ever since week six. You could argue that Buchholz, one way or another, could have eliminated them because there were, you know, a decent chunk of 5-3 teams that didn't make playoffs based off their Buchholz score. But Michigan State's opponents were just so high quality. Like I mentioned, their losses are all against playoff quality teams, all against top 11 teams in the final Bukul standing. So they really had nothing to worry about in terms of their final placing in the seeding to make playoffs. Once we get past this 18-second cooldown, we'll get into the map vetoes, where I haven't done a whole lot of sitting. What I do know is just the generalities that I think Michigan State generally has not been playing Anubis. Let me pull up their most recent match. Indeed, Michigan State has been first banning Anubis, and that shouldn't change against the Jaguars. The Jaguars have played Anubis at least one time, and I think floated it in almost every single match thus far. So Michigan State should stay true to that ban. I don't. Looks like Inferno was the leftover map here. I would be surprised. I would be shocked even to see IEPY even let that into the realm of picking for Michigan State. Michigan State in this match picked Overpass. Virginia was able to best them in that, but I'll go ahead and go back and check one more time. I think Overpass has been Michigan State's strong suit, but they didn't actually end up picking it here. We'll see if it was first banned by RIT. I know that some RIT rosters have played Overpass. I've seen them play playoff matches in an ACCS and face a collegiate actually on Overpass. I've seen old Franz whiff a spray on a Heaven player. Very vividly, I remember these things. Well, it looks like face it doesn't want to load. Here we go, maybe. Oh, it isn't even loading the other two maps. This page looks a little bit busted, so we won't be able to tell, but I would not be surprised to see if Michigan State rock an Overpass pick here. Both lineups just being finalized. Gonna add Cocaster Jack XCDG to the call here. So, as far as this lineup goes for IEPY, I think this is, I think, only the second time this season we've seen this five, and this is nearly the exact same five that we saw go deep in collegiate playoffs last spring. Obviously, Yeti was a part of that five, but the difference here, I think, being Sherlock. Not positive. Inferno and Anubis banned as expected, and would not be surprised to see both Overpass and Ancient be selected. Ancient on the IUPUI side and Michigan State on the Overpass side. That being said, I don't know if I've seen. It's been a long time since I've seen IUPUI actually have to first pick. They've been on the right side of the face it match pages for a long time, but because they have the high seed here, face it is defaulting them towards the first pick. Now, personally, when I'm the higher seed, I like to defer to my opponent so I have, kind of perfect information, as perfect as it can get. But face it has decided otherwise in this case.
Yeah, but we'll definitely see Ancient here picked up from the IPY side.
Both picks have already been made. These teams knew what they were picking coming in. Nuke already banned and Ancient overpass Vertigo. So yeah, I'm not surprised at all by this.
Definitely something that IPY is going to be very okay with.
Yeah, so interestingly, IEPY floated Mirage into that last pick. I'm not surprised by that, but Vertigo being the decider is interesting, and I think IEPY will actually enjoy that more than they would enjoy Mirage, but we'll see how it works out. Me get this IP in and send you it. My CSGO is working.
This, of course, the last collegiate CSGO season before Source 2 release in Counter-Strike 2.
It's actually a good point. Yeah, I mean, I would assume now that you've mentioned that, I mean,
Yeah, it's
there's
something we didn't
probably going to
really
be a
think.
decent chunk of money in these seasons next season if they're trying to promote the league and such. But we'll see. Bad
Yeah.
time for IEPY. They're losing. I mean, this is the senior season for both Straylock and Big Daddy A at the very least.
Yeah.
We might see more of Tristan CMX and Blake Gumboot, but all right, cool. It's working. I'll send you the IP. This is going to be modified for your purposes. You can just copy paste this.
So kind, so kind.
Yeah, I changed two digits.
So yeah, coming up on Ancient here. I expect IEPY to probably win this match 2-0. I guess Overpass could be an anomaly, but with the amount of play time that they have on the map. I see.
I'm really interested to see where Big Daddy A ends up on Overpass, because I guarantee they really haven't scrimmed. But I know that Andy has really not enjoyed his previous roles on that map and has been playing a lot more towards the A bomb site or B rotator. So I'll be interested to see what they start with on the CT side. We'll know immediately, obviously, once that map starts. But I'm almost positive they played Ancients against Virginia. Yeah, they lost Ancient 16-13 against Virginia, so it was close. Other than that, they haven't played Ancient since February 18th, so earlier in the season. They were able to win 16-12. I'll look at what team this was. This was against Clemson, which is another quality team.
Who picked Ancient, the Virginia one?
Give me a sec. No, it was Virginia. Virginia picked Ancient. Yeah. So I'm going to just say did get whatever side they chose. I say that because I'm sure there's some teams that prefer T-side start on Ancient right now. I will give Michigan State props. As a collegiate organization, they are one of the few that I see constantly kind of use their own university's kind of branding and such in their profile picks and kind of team logos and such. I would be shocked to see these players have scholarships, so it's really just coming from the soul of the players and the motivation there.
No, they don't. It's esports though is a very big club over at Michigan State. I've got to attend a couple LANs there.
I took a quick look at their Twitter recently. I saw that they did one of those gamers outreach LANs. I don't know what the attendance was like, but I think unsurprisingly Michigan State was able to win. So moving into the discussion on Ancients, the last few games for IEPY on this map.
Let me just try to do some vocal.
Have been
vocal warm up.
Very strong performances for Big Daddy A, we'll say.
I hate Mickers. I hate Mickers.
All right, ready.
You're saying?
As I was saying, Big Daddy A has been playing fantastically on Ancient, not only on the CT side, but also on the T side. I think, honestly, the two games we watched, it was really a case of domination on either side. I think the first time we saw him on Ancient this season was on his Caves, kind of like op domination. And then the second game we watched, IEPY had a very, very rough start, but his Big Daddy A was able to pretty much single-handedly put IEPY back into the server. I think he ended the half with like 21 kills or maybe even higher than that, and ended the game with 41, I think. 40 or 41. Yeah,
it was a lot.
So if that Big Daddy A shows up, there is really no reason that IEPY shouldn't be able to take their map pick of Ancient.
Did you talk about that, by the way, about the op situation, or just in general that like IPY has been looking to either incorporate more double op setups or we might see more of a rifle from Gumboot?
Yeah, well, I mean specifically on Ancient, like the op position is kind of shifted from. I mean, I don't know if it was ever really a mid position. But
can't
like
be
people because of this angle that exists on back lane all the way down to ramp, the op has kind of been moved away from constantly kind of police itself around mid and try to find picks onto window or from donut. It pretty much just become a B site specialty weapon. There are a lot of oppers that at least on the pro level like to mix in caves peaks and caves holds as a part of their kind of op mix-up routine. But we know and we've seen earlier this season that Big Daddy A loves to take that AWP into caves. It'll just be a matter of whether IEPY manages the economy, whether they want to double op, whether Big Daddy A is feeling like the op is a good weapon for him in this matchup. The AWP allows you to kind of do something very specific in caves, which is play in that small choke point that can't be easily Molotoved and still find fragging impact. Whereas if you're on a rifle, that's a very easily pre-aimable and hard to win fight. Sometimes T's will get greedy and just throw that bounce Molotov and just say, okay, caves must be clear, peek into an AWP and die. So that's what they'll be looking for in that case. But we'll have to wait 15 rounds to see that at least. T-side start for the IEPY Jaguars, since this is their own map pick. Michigan State is elected to start the CT side. IEPY likely going to be going mid to A into a double A stack, so this is not going to be the easiest round ever. Babe Nation takes this first fight into Donut, falling back. BJDA is not slowing down at all. This running Glock is running his opponent over. Babe Nation goes down, and now the retake is on for the CTs. There is a kit on Pig, but it'll be a matter of fragging before they can actually get to using that. Straylock gonna flash his teammate into the CT peak. Tristan finds three CTs. Big Daddy 8 able to find one and a second. Blade trying to pick up the pieces. Two versus three now, but both CTs on very low HP, and you're gonna need to hit these headshots. Straylock on no armor. Seems like struggling a bit as well, but Big Daddy 8, we already called his name, and he has called his own name as well. 4-0 to start the half. This has really just been Big Daddy 8's map these last few.
This is Big Daddy 8's playground. Insta 4K on pistol, already showing people why, if you haven't realized that this is his map. Even hits him with a get mogged mine. Just a simple mid to A, and they hold the post plan. Very clean round for IPY.
Michigan State incorporating a B stack here. I don't think that they're going to be interested in rushing. More so interested in trying to trap IEPY in maybe a bit of a lazy anti-eco round. Now, because the B site pretty much has no cover on the actual bomb site and has very easily malleable spots like Cubby and Pillar, any kind of diligence and their execute should result in a pretty clean round win, even if they end up at B, IEPY that is. That being said, it doesn't really look like the Molotov is going to be used on the site. Instead, into Cave. Wallbang's coming in, but they're not going to catch Danny, at least on the first time around. Looks like there's a bit of an interest in walking down ramp. Gonna back out of it in time. There are a lot of players that IEPY have already spotted, but looks like they're gonna commit anyway. Going very well thus far. No deaths yet for the Jaguars, and they will end the round with no deaths. The USPs and the P250s find nothing for MSU, and that is a clean five alive.
Yeah, very by the book kind of start there for IEPY. Playing that eco run really smart, grouped up, and being there to trade, but they didn't even need to trade anyone else to get all five. First Byron comes in, Michigan State gonna be pretty low on util.
IEPY not looking to do anything special here, it looks like. Maybe just a bit of a mid-default. CMX realizes there's no utility early, but Pig with the late nade and the spam actually does lower Gumboot down to 20 HP. That's a very solid utility combo that caught off IEPY there. Expecting nothing, receives quite a bit of damage. And that's kind of the meta for Ancient mid right now. It's the CTs trying to at least create a nuisance for the T side. They know it's very hard to fight a rushing T side team in the middle, but sometimes just damage and stalling can be enough to make mid at the very least manageable from an information perspective. Pig gonna go out on a lurk smoke. Gumboot seems to be wary of the possibility, but will he be able to see him in time? Big Daddy A instead will find that first, and coordinated double A main push from Babe Nation and Danny Cool. This is not something that you see all that much, especially in pugs on an ancient game. Straylock getting caught out. I think the server lagged out a bit there. I wonder if the players felt that. Positions will be known A main. Smoke from Big Daddy A will give the bomb space to work with, and he's already had one kill in the round. He's a reverse James Bond right now, 7-0, being boosted up by his teammate on the tree. This was a silent boost. Michigan State should not have been able to hear that. CMX holding mid, shoulder spotted for Blade. I think reverse can be said as well. Flashes come in, Gumboot goes down. Now Big Daddy A, he needs to hit these shots. He finds Danny, looking away. He doesn't expect the second, and he goes down for it. Blade goes down as well, though, in the mid push, and both players don't have for IEPY. There is no smoke for the CT side. There's also no kit. This is a full 10-second defuse. Tristan needs to swing out and stop the defuse. He's able to get a first kill, but the defuse was stopped. And Aiden on 9 HP is going to try to run away. This bomb radius has been so high, he goes down. So IEPY, they win the round and completely demolish the economy of this Michigan State Spartans.
Yeah. Big Daddy finding the opening pick on, I think it was Pig. Interesting play to try to lurk through that smoke there. And you know, Michigan State, you know, played it pretty well. Double pushed A main. When they killed Strelak, Strelak only saw the one and never saw the second guy. He never had to swing out. So Big Daddy was caught off there, but the lack of kit and lack of util and a donut retake is just like pretty much a terrorist win every time. Yeah. And then the bomb radius on top of that, no save allowed for the CTs, and everyone's going to be broke here.
And this is like a hybrid save force by it. Started off very well. You don't see the CZ all that much. Two CZs for Michigan State. C-Mex and Big Daddy A doing their part in cleaning it up. Aiden with a Deagle. Chips in on a Big Daddy A. Pure chaos around the map right now. Pistol fighting, rifles everywhere. Michigan State able to recover a rifle for Aiden. He has body armor.
They should know that the last two are were caves.
So yeah, the bomb is headed over to the A bomb site right now. CTs realize the situation they're in, start to make a gamble, rotate towards A at the same time. Bomb being planted. They're on the Michigan State side, this is so difficult. The exact same situation they're in, they were in last round. There's no smoke and there's no kit for this donut position. And the T's can really just play so many different, very small pixel angles that can get them enough information to know that they don't have to swing. Tristan making those exact same jiggle peaks right now. Aiden trying to creep up. Spots out and completely destroys Tristan. One tap there very quickly. CMX running from mid to help out Gumboot. Not expecting Aiden so close. Bame Nation with one dig onto Gumboot. There's no time for this defuse, but a fantastic eco round. It has to be said for Michigan State. A lot of economic damage done for the Spartans onto the Jaguars.
Yep. It was definitely a lot of good damage there. Nice double cave stack, giving Aiden the AK and letting Aiden work. Aiden will be a focal point for this Michigan State team if they want to have any sort of chance. He is their star player, and he has to step up for the team. Blade's going to pick up an op here, no Yutsu, so we're going to see the first op in the game on the CT side, as well as Michigan State having full Yutsu. So this round is the first important round.
Well, they brought the op to B, and it's going to be a B rush for Aipa. They are scaling up so fast. The flashbang from Strela completely blinds Blade, and that AWP has been followed. Tristan not stopping for anything, just knocks Pig out of the round. And this should be a save for Michigan State so quickly. The flashes from Straylock are perfect. Blade trying to find even just a shred of a kill goes down. Michigan State, they did find a kill onto Straylock. I wonder if that'll coax them into going for it, but no, Aiden makes the call. Gonna run away. And the AWP that Tristan was able to find has been passed over to Big Daddy A, and he has done damage with that exact weapon on this map before. I wouldn't be surprised to see it maybe toss over to Gumboot to start on the T side. Looks like Michigan State will be able to retain at least a couple of their guns. CMX was able to find Aiden before the bomb collected his life away. Free fire from the M4 almost tells on himself, but he is able to live.
Yep, first true buy run in the game, and 99% is called by the IPY, and they do it beautifully. Force as a save, as Michigan State is going to force into this round with those 36 guns. A scout, though, only on Blade.
Only one B on this default for IPY. Definitely showing their hand with a mid preference. Babe Nation, he's in front of Donut. Gumboot, not ready for this at all. Whips out a flashbang, gets punished immediately. Aiden, meanwhile, finds the solo B defaulter in Straylock and Jaguar. So Michigan State finally looking good for a round win. Finds two early kills completely untraded. The Jaguars are going to have to try to find some way to get back into this round. Economic damage is relevant, as the CTs are nearing zeros in their bank account every time they're buying up these at this stage in the game, being down 5-0. What's been interesting to me thus far is that we've seen a lot of 2A from Michigan State to not only start, but also in the mid round. IPY are going to try to piece together an A execute here. Slant and lane smokes thrown. Actually, no lane smoke. It was actually a cave smoke that was thrown. We got A posting on lane. He'll be much more effective than a smoke grenade. CMX finds Pig. Big Daddy A finds Babe Nation on the rotation. So now we're in a 2v2. Rotates just now firing in the middle on the flank. CMX inching up on Blade here. Not spotted yet, but we'll find a back turned effectively. What was a 3v5 favoring the Spartans has now become a 1v2 clutch for Danny Cool. Does he have ice in his veins, as his name suggests? He finds Big Daddy A. CMX on 7 HP is able to find that. Danny clearly seemed a bit jump scared there by CMX's location. I don't know if it's the pressure of the playoff match or what, but Danny did not seem ice cool in that clutch.
Yeah, Michigan State does a good job finding the first two opening picks, but IPI just decides to go back into a B execute, and it just works perfectly. Big Daddy A finding a Aiden swinging lane with no util or anything, and with an op, he's gonna not gonna miss those as he gets two kills, and fast CMX picks up three on a nice
lurk. This is a perfect fast call. I mean, this is another Michigan State force buy, and IPI has completely made the right call, but. Oh, the rotation from Bay Mation actually beats the smoke grenade, and Tristan peeking in front of it will go down. But the two following kills go the way of the Jaguar. Spring with the A1S is Aiden. He collects one, but not before Sherlock can get away before Sherlock finds him. Two versus three now. Gumboot on such low HP. Big Daddy, we've seen his AWP be an enforcer of choke points. This time, won't even need it. Sherlock catching out Blade, trying to make a play through the smoke grenade. Sherlock now going to try to plant. Has the bomb out, but Gumboot so quick on the headshot. Double kill for Gumboot in that round. Two important kills, it must be said. Basically protecting teammates in both cases.
Yeah. Michigan, or IUPUI calling him a fast day, and it worked. It was definitely the right call, but Michigan State honestly played that pretty good. They threw a defensive lurk smoke to get out of Valorant, as well as flashes. The flashes, though, unfortunately blinded their teammate. If those flashes were better, or behind them, they might be able to swing out, and Michigan State might have gotten their first round there. But
danger for Big Daddy A here. Those nades, not going to collect anything but one damage, and that is going to be a lot of information gained for IUPUI. Great spray by Gumboot to find that headshot on the Babe Nation, but this is an open B bomb site. Michigan State staring right in the face. Will they? I mean, they could hypothetically collect this bomb. Oh, Pig not going to guess that timing. Gumboot will get deke spammed. Big Daddy A with the NMVP posted, ready for any rotation. And I think Spartans are probably considering saving this AK. Just in catching a shoulder. Danny Cool catching some shots into Tristan. Big Daddy collects that kill, and Pig is on the run to save this AK-47. So IUPUI already halfway to 16 and half as many rounds. Michigan State, I'm surprised we haven't seen a tactical timeout called by the Spartans. This has been a rough showing on the CT side.
Yeah, this is definitely not a good way to start if you want to have any chance to take your opponent's map pick. 8-0 down. I've seen teams come back down from 10-0 though, so never say never.
Big Daddy A is in a place where he just double killed and his ADR decreased. That is special.
This is Big Daddy A's playground.
So, once again, no timeout called by the Spartans. Babe Nation gonna op up here. This is a full buy. There's really nothing to complain about from a utility perspective or a gun perspective for Michigan State. So this is the round that they really need to turn it around. CMX gonna challenge their Jaguar fast. Aiden challenging back, finds the first kill. Tristan trades, but not before being dinked. So a good start from Aiden. Big Daddy catches Pig trying to get aggressive mid. We saw Big Daddy make that post last round. He wasn't able to collect anything. Blade running M41's headshot through the wall. And that evens up the score in this round. Three alive for either side. Interesting dynamic here. Babe Nation posted on ramp. I don't think he realizes that Gumboot is up the ramp. If Gumboot inches along the wall on his crawl, oh, he peeks into the lane player, and the Sherlock flashbang was meant for slant, not for that deep lane position. IPLI lose their lurk and starting to lose their footing in this round. Danny Cool from Elbow is going to be a distraction for Blade to flank Big Daddy A and Straylock. 1v3, trying to isolate duels. This is not going to be easy, getting flanked so quickly. Michigan State is on the board one round. They're going to need a lot more than that, though.
Yep, they are. Great round for Blade on... Was it Blade on the op? Yeah, it was Blade on the op. I think it was Blade's op. They got two kills.
It was Babe Nation on the op.
Well, Straylock has bought a G3. Anyways, you're right. Blade found two kills without the op, but he picked up his double op. Michigan State picking up their much needed first round as Grub Smoke has been deployed. Grubway
has been deployed. Usually you don't send four people with a Grubble, but it is what it is. Danny Cool spots out the mid aggression from IEPY. There are three players towards the same bomb site. That smoke will be a very good stopping point. Prevents the Jaguars from scaling into Donut. Next fight is Babe Nation. He collects Big Daddy A. Aiden finds Gumboot on the ramp pushdown. Still a player aggressive. That's Blade down the ramp. Just gonna say still a man up, but without mid control currently. Sherlock fighting for that. Wins the duel onto Pig and Donut. Really fights going on all around the map. Tristan trying to make his way into Cave. Blade with the AWP. He's ready. Shuts Tristan down. Still double AWP up for Michigan State. The two players they lost early, both on the rifles. So the expensive guns still alive. Meanwhile, on the T side, there still is quite an expensive gun. See, the most expensive gun in the game. I think SCAR 20 might actually be more expensive, but...
The M249, I think, is the most expensive gun in the game.
Well, that's a disgrace. That gun is terrible.
5,200, right? And then that's 5,000 on both sides.
Well, are we going to see a 1v3 with it? That's a start. Didn't find it with the... Oh, he swapped out. You know what? Deserved. Should have stayed on the auto sniper. Now the CTs literally never heard that auto sniper shoot, and now they're looking down and they see it. And they've scooped
it. And they
taked it. Uh-oh. Wow. All I gotta say is if Michigan State starts mounting a comeback with the auto sniper only purchased in a misbuy by Straylock, it would be very, very, very funny.
We'll see who takes that. I think Babe Nation will keep it. Another good round for Michigan State there. Making aggressive plays, walking down, and essentially picking off people or IPY Jaguars one by one.
Yeah, I mean, one good thing that we've seen from the Spartans is their coordinated kind of mid-round aggressive pushes as a CT side looking for information. We saw that both towards A main, it collected Straylock and gave them a pretty favorable post plant that they weren't able to convert on. And then we saw in that round the double walk down B ramp like you almost would on as a CT on Nuke. Blade gonna find Tristan with his AWP, and there is a lot of pressure into Cave. Aiden gonna find that. IPY struggling to find some footing in these last couple of rounds, especially in their defaults. Michigan State starting to win fights, and I mean, I think that's really been the difference. A lot of times that we've seen IPY win, most of the rounds that IPY won in that 8-round span were really one-on-site executes. You know, you even think back to the 3 versus 5, they lost the fights in the default, but the execute was so good that IPY was able to win. This time, now an A execute starting to spawn. Danny deploys a smoke to get himself some space. Not able to find Straylock, though. Only damage. Babe Nation with the auto sniper. Gets the first, and the Molly will stall Big Daddy A away from trading. Bomb dropped in the hallway. This is not going to be really a winnable round unless Big Daddy A does the impossible. Finds the first without taking any damage. How ready is he for the flank, though? Staring right at it until he wasn't. Blade will collect that. Double kill on the round for him, and Michigan State starting to bounce back here.
Yep. IPY is going to be forced to save here, too, so this is a good chance to get four. But Michigan State was able to get two ops, and now the auto sniper, they're just using them to get picks. Like, this double op setup has been working wonders for Michigan State, essentially walking in the angles that IPY aren't flashing off or anything. We're going to see 99% here. B-Rush.
Very quick rush indeed. Not blind is Aiden, who collects two quick ones. Still 8 bullets in the magazine. Plenty to get a second kill, a third one, and he will collect. The USP is brought out the full blind Straylock. Able to find a Tech-9 kill, but that's not going to be a round win. Straylock actually double killing on the round. Aiden on Pillar does a very good job to stay alive for that long, though. Found just enough of a gap in those staggered flashbangs. IEPY decides against an AWP there. I think Straylock, that might have been the deliberation at the end there. Tristan gets team knifed. Not a good start for IEPY. See what the utility is. Oh, yo, Pig is out in the open. Big Daddy A finds that one for free. No nade to slow down the T's timing. And Big Daddy A is not slowing down at all. Once again, Danny gets jump scared. I wonder if the pressure of this playoff match is getting to him, because that is the second time he's had a pretty much free kill and has just flicked off his opponent. Fights going on all around the map, but the auto sniper will be IEPY's next target unless they pivot towards a B execute.
Babe Nation on Big Box. Spawn, I think they're waiting for him.
Yeah, he seems to be pretty content with holding the flank, though. I think they might even wait for CMX to find this B player. If Aiden falls, it could be a path onto B, but CMX smokes it off, seemingly declaring their intent towards the A bomb site. Is Aiden going to try to mess around with the smoke? No, but Babe Nation will try to push Donut. I wonder what has spurred him into action here. What? He actually almost found Tristan. He no-scoped him in the chest, but it's not enough damage. And Aiden gets collected going through the smoke by CMX. What a chaotic run.
I wasn't on Tristan's POV there. He must have quick-switched or something? Or
yeah, I don't know. Like, it seemed like Tristan was going to find that kill for free, but
Babe Nation, then he took a step.
Wow, that was crazy.
Yeah, but Michigan State there, who was it? Not Danny. Who was first? Who ran out mid?
Pig. It was Pig.
Yeah, yeah, Pig just runs out mid, gets killed. Danny decides to just try to deploy a smoke, even though he heard Big Daddy A up, and Big Daddy pushes that. And
once again, quick mid. There are three players don't hit for Michigan State, though. They have a fantastic setup to stop this. Early fights won by Michigan State. Trades not available yet. Aiden still in the back of Donut. Well, I even realized that there were three here. Aiden does go down. Quick rotation by the CTs away. They're still on B. The bomb, however, is still down in mid. I wonder if Blade's going to be ready for the T's running back. If he goes elbow here, he might be able to hear these players running a main. IEPY is quite afraid right now that their opponent knows that the bomb is down. A game of kind of misinformation on both sides. What will the T's decide to do? They're actually going to opt to route through mid rather than go back through A main. So much time has passed. Blade looking towards the A bomb site. Now looking back towards mid. Finds CMX. Seemed a bit surprised by that. Now Straylock is the next fight. Smoke goes behind him. Straylock wins the fight. Now it's just down to Pig. Trying to redeem himself for last round. Trying to pick up the A1S. I don't think the E key was working there.
Yep. Almost a potential throw there from IEPY leaving the bomb and spawn and taking the site because by the time they got bombed, the Michigan State was already aware, but they were able to find those kills, and only having a scout there is not a good chance for the 1v2.
It's also worth the discussion that Michigan State had three players donut there and were not able to close the round. They do. Okay, yeah. Once again, Michigan State has the right setup. There are three players B, but they all decide to go cave, and cave's going to get smoked. Aiden goes through the smoke to try to contest. Gumboot not ready for the pillar. Gumboot's just planning without clearing pillar. He goes down. Tradis had Big Daddy and Straylock find kills. And now it's just a full retake. Aiden almost turned that round on its head. Not good enough, though. Straylock fighting into cave will win it on the Blade. CTs have to go for this retake. Last round of the half. Babe Nation with the ump. Quick catch on into Tristan. Molly's coming in, though. This is the perk of taking the bomb site with early in the round and a lot of util. You have util to expend. Nice headshot from Danny on the Big Daddy. But CMX trades, and I mean, I'm not surprised by this halftime score really at all, especially considering Big Daddy is 19 kills, 123 ADR, leading the way for the Jaguars. Aiden almost equally leading the way for Michigan State in the ADR department, but it's only been enough for four rounds.
Yeah, very, very strong half from IPY there on their map pick. Big Daddy once again still showing why it's his playground. As we're going to see a B rush, it looks like, from the Michigan State side. And we'll see a mid mod from IPY, which we'll realize quickly. That was a B contact.
Michigan State actually didn't rush. They stopped and took fight's window. And these USPs at long range are winning the fights right now. Aiden running up onto site. There are still two more CTs trying to push onto ramp. Big Daddy A can't win this fight. Oh, man. This is a collegiate playoff match, and both players are struggling. Blade narrowly makes it to the bomb site, but Sherlock and Big Daddy A, they punish those peaks. And Big Daddy A, once again, already off to a good start in the pistol round. Two kills for him on a 21. And the Gator is out. IEPY defeated Florida in their last game of the season, and because they're on Duelist Kingdom, IEPY was able to take Florida's best card, and that best card was the Gator. Big Daddy has collected it and will be using it. There is no one actually to receive this, though. All five players for Michigan State towards the A bomb site right now, or towards mid. A split inevitable, it seems. And Straylock and Tristan, they'll be the pinpoints here. That smoke from Tristan is so well timed, though. Same goes for Straylock. Michigan State, they were pretty heavily dependent on hitting this bomb site while the utility mid was still up and Gumboot is taking every advantage. He only finds one, though. No effort to flank yet from BDIDA now being spurred into action. Meanwhile, the T side headed back towards B from T spawn. Only one mid lurk remains. That's Danny. Only on 5 HP. There is still two smoke grenades up on Michigan State. They've just deployed one. I don't know, actually. Oh, he's thrown it to a teammate. I thought he actually used it to execute. There goes one of the smokes. They've Nation holding onto the second. Smoking lane. No lineup needed, I suppose. CMX going to try to punish that. Can't, so... Oh, that lane smoke has mine. Maybe they should have used the lineup. That lane smoke leaves a lot to be desired. And so does the strike from Michigan State, unless Babe Nation can win this round. He almost does. That almost looks like it was going to be a Deagle collateral clutch. And that may have, you know, given Michigan State enough momentum to start to spur a comeback. The bomb plant will at least give them enough money to buy next round. But 13 rounds is still achieved.
Yep. Definitely made it closer than you would have thought. But either way, like, do get the bomb down, which allows them to buy into this round, which they are going to choose to do. So their buy looks better, honestly, than IP-wise, gun-wise. Yeah.
Wow. Once again, an A-side focus for Michigan State. I'd say the meta right now is unequivocally towards the B-bomb site.
I think with the lack of util, they're just trying to do a contact out A with AKs.
Wow, Blade has just destroyed the aggressive CT default, and that has caused rotations, and Michigan State is lurking out onto the A-bomb site for absolutely free. Tristan, here's the smokes laying down. There's no way he expects someone to already be donut. Wow, Babe Nation didn't get that kill. Tristan, a lot of the second lease on life, but Blade quickly shuts that down. Sherlock and Jaguar, Blade currently on for the A's, gets shut down. But the hunt is on. The T side not going to want to let these CTs save these weapons. Sherlock. 3 HP finally goes down. Pig gets his fourth kill of the match.
One kill per round win.
Well, that's about to be ruined. Gotta go
find five. Gotta go find five.
I mean, the T side economy is quite low, so I can see why they wouldn't want to chase. I'd still argue for it, but... They're going to stay. What a round from Blade. Just walks into B and finds three headshots. I mean, it is worth noting that Big Daddy A and Tristan were both off of SMGs and shotguns, but, I mean, he single-handedly wins the round for this
part. He does. He wins the round, causing the rotation from the IPI side.
Yeah, that rotation doesn't show up at Leagueify. Only the kills do.
Big Daddy opting into the semi-gator when his team saves, so
smoke we'll be looking to try to make it funny back. I wonder if Gumboot will be able to make an impact on a one-way here. He finds the first, sprays onto the second, can't find the kill, though. Now CMX, he's next up to the plate. With his Deagle, finds the first. That's definitely a one-way. Big Daddy with the shotgun finds another. So two versus two. And Pig, he's only on four kills. He's going to need to make an impact for his team this round. This is a very complicated mid round for the T side. They don't have bomb in their possession, and they really didn't really have anyone over towards A default. Pig, this is going to be so awkward. He will find CMAX. That's a free kill. And now Big Daddy with just a mag 7 and half HP needs to find a way back into this round. Doesn't seem like he wants to do it quietly either. He thinks that this is just going to be an A hit. Will he be ready for Pig in this corner? Seems like he is. USP whipped out, not clearing it. Pig will find two important late round kills for his squad. And Michigan State starting to mount a decent T side here.
Yep. And now Pig up to six kills for six rounds. He made up for it. Gumboot had an opportunity to get a multi frag there using the one way. Unfortunately, the spray wasn't good enough to find two. Big Daddy A couldn't find enough with his semi gator. And Michigan State played that mid-round pretty well there.
So this is a pretty popular anti-eco play these days, just to hit A very quickly. There's long-range angles, not a whole lot of cubbies for ecoing players to hide in. Very hard to stack this bomb site, and Michigan State will be reaping the benefits of their correct call. Pig may be reaping the benefits of some eco kills. Finds CMX, finds Straylock very quickly and twitchy onto all three kills. Now, if those were against rifles, it might be a highlight, but instead it will only show up has ADR in the stat sheet. Tristan, no kit, so really no potential to ninja here. And I should say it looks... Vape Nation seemed to flash himself there. Mason with a 5-7, finds the first, can't find Aiden though. Not a whole lot of money damage either, so Michigan State not only has three straight rounds won, but also a bank built up in case they need to buy up later.
Yep, they definitely do. As we'll see another buy round here. Big Daddy opting the op, so we'll see that op go into the caves. As APY looks to finish this map off relatively quickly.
Quick mid play from Michigan State. The nade does so much damage, and Gumbu spraying through the smoke finds 1.5. Big Daddy A's AWP and cave that we talked about in the pre-match already finding an impact onto Blade, and this is the IEPY CT side that we've come to expect. Very well coordinated. You didn't see Straylight get caught out like Pig did in the first half on his mid-default. The nade was good from both players. The spray was even better. And now, I mean, what do you do? We saw IEPY win this exact same situation in the last half with a B execute, but there's only one smoke grenade on the Michigan side, and there's no AWP to hold lane. Big Daddy A already on this AWP angle, trying to bait out the shot. They succeed. They'll take cave in the meantime. No repeat, but the smoke immediately follows from CMX. Very coordinated defense right now for IEPY. That redirects the T side back towards mid. No one immediately in the presence to receive this. Straylock deploying an off angle right now in Donut. T side trying to make a bit of a unexpected play. That flashbang will may reveal their locations. Pig, though, great entry onto Gumbu. Big Daddy makes the trade happen onto Danny. Straylock will find one, and Tristan will find the last onto Pig. So IEPY onto 14, just two rounds away from moving us onto Overpass a lot quicker than I expected.
Yeah, definitely thought it would be more close. It never say never, though. Still plenty of time for Michigan State to try to mount a comeback. But IPY has just been playing so coordinated well, coordinated and very, very good CS on this map. Showing why they're a top six team in collegiate.
So quick boost up onto Slant for Babe Nation. None of the IEPY players currently occupying that location, but if Babe Nation sticks it out long enough, you can find some unexpected rotators, particularly if, you know, Big Daddy A goes down, Gumboot rotates to Slant, that could be an opportunity for a kill. Looks like the first opportunity for a kill, though, is going to be on CMX. Lurking up is Blade. Straylock playing a one-way. Aiden seems to have an inkling that this could be a one-way smoke. Aiden comes up and clears it, but Straylock so quick. There's Babe Nation on the boost. Finds CMX rotating back Slant, as we mentioned. Big Daddy A not slowing down for anything, though. Opping wins the fight out of Babe Nation. Babe Nation did shoot first, but not accurately. And Danny Cool had a bit of a timing here. A didn't realize it. Couldn't have realized it, really. He's not on a very favorable angle. He's got to be incredibly close to peeking Tristan. Sherlock finds Pig, trying to exit caves, and Danny Cool once again gets jump scared. That was such a jump scare, he started shooting the sign before he flicked over to Tristan.
Very, very shaky at the keyboard today, Danny Cool.
Have you ever met someone who just jump scared more than Big Daddy A? Because now you have.
As Michigan State down to their last round potential here.
Well, I think I know what they're gonna do.
We're looking at the B rush.
Actually, opting to go K's. Big Daddy A. He actually hits him through the pillar. Molly will stop the immediate rush, but Danny Cool, he's not slowing down. 5-7 whipped out. This is just gonna be a farm for IEPY. That nade literally hits Blade in the chest, and now it's just Aiden AK-47 1v4. Big Daddy spotted him and collects the final kill. So very, very clean map one for IEPY, and it's rare that when you predict particularly a player performance that player does exactly what you expected them to. Big Daddy A dropped 29 kills in 23 rounds. That is certainly above average performance.
It's his map. It is his map. And now we'll go into Overpass.
Yeah, and this is definitely where the series begins. IEPY comes in as the higher seed, finished a whole game win above Michigan State. and that was their map pick. So if Michigan State was ever expected to make an impact in the series, it would start on Overpass. So we'll see what they can bring. Go to a quick break in between maps, and when we have Overpass started, I'll be back. All right, we're back. Still waiting on somebody to ready up. There we go. And IDPI will get to choose their starting side. Unless they're trying to reinvent the Overpass meta, they will go with the CT side. Like I mentioned the pregame, I think, or I shouldn't say I think, I wouldn't be surprised if we see some positional changes, at least with respect to what IEPI has ran in the past. Gumboot, longtime A player, I wouldn't be surprised to see Big Daddy A join Gumboot on the A bomb site once we get to the rifle rounds. Or see Big Daddy A in the B rotator position. IEPI gonna start with four towards A, looking for an A stack, and right now it looks to be the correct call. Four player bathrooms, T side waiting to see if there's any kind of CT aggression. Very slow to start. Pig with the utility. Gonna follow his teammates into playground. IEPI still staying put on their spots. Tristan takes first contact. calling over to his team. Gets gooshed down to 27. Out, Khan goes Babe Nation, immediately goes down. Tristan, full blind, gets pushed, and the Spartans will actually collect two in the process there. Big Daddy on an off angle, not expecting it, is Aiden, but a lot of pressure being put on from multiple angles, and Big Daddy won't be able to find anything else. CMX dancing around Divider, trying to find this kill on a Danny Cool, who's not going to let that happen. Now Straylock, last man alive, rotating up from B, might have to rotate right back down as the skis are flying down connector. He'll start to hear that now. Kit on Straylock means that this retake can be a little bit more methodical than it might have to be otherwise. Door being closed is not going to do him any favor, though both players short, that's not going to be easy to expect, and he's not going to expect it. Danny Cool, three kills in the pistol round, and that's going to be a good start for Michigan State, trying to rebound after the map loss on Ancient. It's also, I think, worth noting that it's a decent rebound for Danny, who I'd say lost at least a couple of key gunfights in the last half due to maybe some nerves. Try to ease the nerves. That Strela gets knifed by a teammate, looking to make this round even shorter than it will be. Aiden with the MAC-10, likely to run into several pushing counter-terrorists here. Tristan flanking playground, gonna be mowed down by Aiden. Gumboot actually with a silencer off finds a kill. Babe Nation collects CMX. And it's really just a matter of time before we see Michigan State find a second round. And I think what's kind of underrated right now is trying to prevent yourself from overusing utility in rounds like this. You currently see Michigan State has a full belt of utility on at least, you know, two or three of their players almost. And I think, oh my god, the wallbang collects Gumboot on the bottom of that boost. And Big Daddy A is just left with the MAC-10 and will go down. But as I was saying, Michigan State not only is saving a lot of value just by staying alive, but also saves, you know, nearly $1,000 in utility per player that they kept alive that had all that utility on them, which, you know, can give yourself a buy at some point later on, or can give you an extra belt of utility when you wouldn't have one otherwise. So I like that for Michigan State. And what I'd like to see here from IUPUI is start making this competitive. First gun round is very important for the CT side, especially when you save one and buy. Puts a lot of pressure on this first gun round that's typically going to be utility stretched. Big Daddy A still playing on this monster position on overpass. I know he's complained about this before. Maybe going to try to shift up his playstyle. All five Spartans congregated towards the B-bomb site, definitely posturing for an execute. Bomb very passive though. Aiden trying to sniff out any very aggressive pushes. Here comes one from Gumboot, but nothing like a T-spawn push. Aiden now realizing, yeah, we spent 40 seconds defaulting towards B. We probably should take a look up at A. And Big Daddy A, he'll find a 1 versus 1 on a lurking Blade. I'm surprised Blade made that lurk, considering there was really no interest in immediately executing B. There was really no possibility of immediately executing B. That kill wouldn't have been much. And Big Daddy A, he collects it without taking a point of damage. Gumboot going to be pressured now. This default, which started B, is now starting to spread its wings towards A. Babe Nation, full belt of utility, peaks without dispersing any of it and gets punished. I said saving utility in the last round was good for Michigan State. Right now, it's not looking nearly as beneficial. Pig going to throw some flashes towards B, try to pull some rotations, or at least keep the CTs on that bomb site. Rest of the T side for the Spartans lurking up towards long. Straylock hasn't jump spotted Aiden yet. This could be a nice chance for the Spartans to lurk up and make a play. And onto the A-bomb site they go. Straylock finds one, Gumboot another, and now it's just down to Aiden, who gets dinked up and taken down. The USP of Gumboot collects, and IEPY, 3k for Gumboot, and very clean first gun round for him.
Very clean first gun round. Michigan State just didn't look coordinated at all in their default there. They made a lot of just solo lurk plays, not really using your util to try to force any CTs out in any position until the very end. And by then, it was already pretty obvious what they were trying to do, and the rotation was already made by APY. So hopefully Michigan State shows more coordination as a team here, or
this game could just be like ancient.
Yeah, and I mean, it's not. You're not going to get punished nearly as hard as IUPUI's economy currently stands for not playing as a team and flashing for each other. But the second you get an off up on the A-bomb site in Gumboot, it's the second that you start getting punished for every little angle that you didn't expect for an upper to be on and didn't flash. This time, Michigan State spreading their default a lot more wide, or a lot wider, I should say. Connector is occupied as well as three towards bathrooms and long for the Spartans. Straylock still retains his divider smoke, and it should be noted that IUPUI is still on three smokes in this round, so a lot of time prevention is still on the cards for IUPUI, and even a third divider smoke could be thrown here by CMX, actually throwing it to Straylock. Pig should have heard that, and that is going to spur Michigan State into action. The flashes Straylock through the divider smoke, but Straylock was able to survive and now smokes himself. Gumboot finds a long lurking player in Babe Nation, and now if you're the T side, how do you handle this? That's a good start on the Straylock. Trade onto Gumboot. And now it's just CMX on back dice. Rotations coming in from both Tristan and Big Daddy A. Meanwhile, the T side with 25 seconds booking it to the B bomb site. There is no smoke to cut off a fast heaven rotate. Is there a fast heaven rotate? There is. Tristan just now arriving, going to drop into pit. That should have been heard by T side. They're not acting like they did. Aiden holding pit. Danny Cool flicks to the head. Big Daddy A, though. Second rotator into heaven finds Aiden. Now 6 seconds. This bomb has to be stuck. Danny Cool is too far into the corner. Did he even have time here? He did get it down, but Big Daddy A very quickly. And CMAX as well from heaven. I was a little bit closer than I expected it to be, but they do come out with the round win.
Danny too cool, man. Yeah, I don't know if he's that cool, man. There are a lot of nerves in that the way he's been playing. But IUPUI with the three-man ace stack early, working on wonders, and the trades were there, forcing Michigan State to save this round. So a good chance for IUPUI to take the lead here on Overpass.
Yeah, Eagles bought up, but this is not a particularly easy map to win without utility, and these mollies are going to do a decent chunk of damage to Aiden for pushing into playgrounds. Common pattern on these CT defaults thus far for IUPUI has been pretty much no one contesting at least the early stages of long. And Michigan State has waltzed their way all the way up long. Gumboot is the closest player to the long crawl. But now Aiden already crept up onto this bomb site. Gumboot still in bathroom. CMX gets the call and will find the kill onto Pig and doubles up onto Aiden. So, crisis averted for the Jaguars. Danny Cool can't find it. CMX and Gumboot a full house, and IUPUI up 3-2.
Yeah, very coordinated, very clean stuff. CMX rotating up, realizing teammates letting him know that they could be up long on site. Finds up 3 kills after Gumboot found the opening 2. IUPUI takes the lead here. We're going to see a Krieg from Babe Nation. Makes you excited, Caleb?
Yeah, I suppose. This is the second round in a row we've seen these double mollies from IUPUI. Aiden, man, just disrespecting it every time. We'll cost him 25 HP. Quick a default for Michigan State. Divider Smoke also quickly dispersed for IUPUI. Short retake comes in for the Jaguars. Blade willing to give that one up. Gumboot on an off-angle divider. We'll find Pig. Long push coming in again. Aiden very quickly. This is pretty much a repeat of last round, this time with guns. And unfortunately for Michigan State, they are not finding an advantage with it. Gumboot still close connector. Danny Cool is just not even close to ready for it. Aiden did find Straylock on the bomb side. Babe Nation also finds a kill with his Krieg on a Gumboot. But with the bombs, just so far away. How much can you really do with Aiden's lurk? Tristan looking out truck. He'll find the kill, and now 1v3. I mean, this is the danger of dropping the bomb in such a separated place every single round. It really just hampers your ability to make any kind of quick, impulsive plays like Aiden was really able to allow for Michigan State that round. CMX, first point of contact. Let us be Bombside Babe Nation deploys a smoke. Very nice headshot on the CMX. Gives himself a shot in this round. 1v3 turned into 1v2. Flash to give him space. Looking towards heaven. No one will arrive there. The scoped Krieg could aid in his fight into Tristan, and it does. Now 1v1. Only on 22 HP. Big Daddy A won't need much. And he's able to collect. So IEPY, they survive Babe Nation's clutch attempt and we'll move it to 4-2.
Yeah, that Krieg came close. Krieg came close for sure, but IEPY winning most of the fights, and even when Michigan State Aiden pushes up and essentially takes the 8 bomb site, him and Babe Nation, they don't have the bomb because they left the bomb back in spawn. It's again showing their just lack of coordination. I don't know if it's nerves or what, because this is their map pick, but just like not being prepared and ready for any of their situations early.
Sherlock going to use his spawn to try to get an op pick and a connector. He'll find nothing, however. Gumboot will have a fast rotation connector. Very quick, short pop for the T side of Michigan State. Big Daddy A still in Monster Tunnel. A little belabored, but finds two and a third with the 5-7. Can he find a fourth? He will. Wow, that was a chaotic 4K for Big Daddy A, but nonetheless, it will be a round win for IEPY.
Michigan State does get the bomb down with the max loss, so they will have a comfortable buy here. But Big Daddy A, honestly lucky that he was able to find the first two there. Cleans it up. And yeah, because of that bomb plant, we will see an op up here on the T side.
It seems
and
simple, but buying a pistol with your A1S, if you can afford it, can make a lot of difference because of the 20 bullets.
It's time to lose my AWP!
They're like having the spawn, so he's going for a fast pick. No one will be there. Oh,
Michigan State really likes to kind of scale up Fountain very quickly. That hedge flash should alert IEPY of Michigan State's intentions. Boost comes in for Babe Nation, but the divider smoke deployed so early for IEPY prevent any information gained from it. Once again, Michigan State kind of depending on A players finding default kills for success in their rounds. And right now, IEPY is playing a style that is basically designed to prevent the T side from finding kills and defaults. These divider smokes completely prevent scaling. Once the clock runs down enough and the smokes are out, CMX makes the rotation to provide another divider smoke. Divider Molly has just been thrown. And without a bomb, even finding a kill at this point is going to be difficult to convert into a round. Babe Nation tags up Gumboot, who wasn't ready for that long angle. Sherlock likely going to request a smoke from CMX divider, and indeed has been thrown. T's, we're seeing three T's just group up around bathrooms right now. So close to the A bomb site. The bomb, however, still down T stairs. CMX finds Aiden through the smoke. Sherlock collects Babe Nation. They can't collect Pig. Gumboot, narrowly misses that shot. I think that was just an impulsive shot through the smoke as well. Flash comes in for Gumboot, no swing. Bomb now being carried over to this A bomb site. Another miss shot from Gumboot. Another miss shot from Gumboot. Back dice goes down. So Michigan State, it looks so bad for them, but now man up situation. Kit on the board for Big Daddy A, not on the board for Tristan. One flashbang to retake with. Will Big Daddy A actually use it? It's looking more and more like no. Michigan State doesn't have the best pulse plans to prevent the bomb defuse, but it will be good enough. And Michigan State, they find their third round, their first gun round of the game as well. I'm really surprised by their ability on the bomb site there.
Yeah, I was really surprised as well. They're able to take it, but Michigan State getting a much needed round win, stopping any bleeding, and trying to keep themselves into this on this not favored side.
So, Sherlock actually gonna go B this round. Big Daddy picks up the AWP and gets punished by Babe Nation. Trying to make that picnic, Pete goes down. IPY, how will they react? This has been probably the most B-centered default we've seen in a while for Michigan State. The one A player that was allocated Will find a kill though. Straight luck with the MP9, looking to find maybe a bit of a timing here. You know you're not going to win most long-range fights. Gumboot, though, he punishes Babe Nation on Picnic. AWP goes down, and now there's literally two AWP sitting up in that party area, but T-Side not interested. They're going to try to contact out Monster here. There's two players close. Tristan finds both in that tunnel. CMX from Barrels trying to create some space for Tristan on the short, and the off-angle for CMX. It's so rare that you actually see T's ready for that off angle, and CMX punishes 6-3 now for IEPY, and that's gonna be a tough pill to swallow for Michigan State.
Yeah, Michigan State finds the opening kill, and it's the one round that they aren't doing their A default, and didn't really do much off of it. IEPY didn't really rotate either; they just held their ground B, and Tristan A doubling up there, and CMX as well. Just strong defense early for IEPY.
IEPY, I think this is the first time we're going to see them kind of operate a long stack. Straylock finds the off kill on a Danny Cool. Flashbang just didn't go deep enough. Michigan State threw the close flash, not the deep flash. That time they throw a deep flash. Straylock caught off guard by the scaling onto Rock, but will find the kill. Pig not able to find the headshot into Straylock. And once again, Michigan State man down in the early stages of a round. Looks like they're trying to make a play quickly onto B, though. Tristan almost gets caught out by Blade and Monster. That flashbang is not going to affect Tristan at all. Gumboot finds rotating players, CMX as well. Now Tristan finds himself on Pillar, goes down to Babe Nation's AWP. It's been quite impactful, but I think this is asking a bit too much. Finds CMX, who is blinded by his teammate's flashbang. Babe Nation can't flick far enough, though, to find Gumboot. Now you go on to 7 rounds in Michigan State. I mean, they're going to be on to kind of a weird force buy here, I think.
Yeah, we will see. They are opting to buy. I would have probably half buy there, but they are opting to, or maybe that was a miss by Vermoslo. Money is messed up over on the Michigan State side.
Yeah, only one full commit in this round.
They are one of the top business schools too, so that is unlucky to see. But regardless, IEQ are looking to take an 8th round.
Quick fight in the connector. Gumboot wins the first fight and the second onto Aiden. His rifle has been on point on these AD fights, and he finds a third headshot onto Pig. Get this man a rifle. He's going insane. Straylock, meanwhile, misses an off shot on a player not looking at him. Misses the repeak shot as well. Babe Nation trying to get away from Gumboot. DDA steals that kill away. Gumboot finds the last player in Blade on stairs. Blade at least gets one constellation frag. Tries to drop down connector. CMX waiting for it and will collect. So, I mean, I hate to say it, but Michigan State just looks kind of lost right now in their defaults.
They do be looking lost in their own map pick, which is a very disheartening sight to see if you're hoping for a close matchup here. As IEPY is in the driver's seat now, just run away with this is. This misjointed buy causes Oslo to only be on a Galil.
I know that they're gonna B rush here. Armit actually stop at the last second. Trying to set up an execute, I suppose. The smoke now being thrown from BIDA might make them reconsider. The last time we saw them group up like this was the last time, I think it was the first gun round of the match we saw Michigan State deploy this exact same default. BIDA up on the grates. Just one flashbang is enough to make this spot horrible, I'll say. But without a flashbang, or without, you know, the T's kind of realizing where they're vulnerable from, like Blade right now, this is the perfect position for Big Daddy A. Oh, Blade doesn't peek. There it is. That's exactly what Big Daddy A wants. And Aiden just swings, no flashbang. Man, Michigan State, where is the coordination? Where is the communication? It just seems like they're tilted. Smoke being thrown in the mid sight with a T side just commit here anyway. This is tough to watch. I mean, Straylock already here on the rotation. Gumboot up on Picnic finds the rotation up to A. Danny Cool goes down, and man, I mean, unless something drastically changes, IEQI is looking like they're changing nothing. 9-3, IEQI winning by 6 rounds already on their opponent's map pick. Unless Michigan State turns this
need a map or what?
Like a 5.
You can't let Blaker's rifle like this against you, Justin. You cannot let me rifle like
Blaker's
this.
Look at this fucking guy. Holy shit. I'm
yeah,
shit.
I mean, it's actually, it's a good point from the
not
kind
sure
of
my rifle.
Joking, like, by the IEPY side. Gumboot. If Gumboot had hit the kind of, we'll say, easy op shots he had access to on dice, he would probably be on like 20 kills right now. But instead, only he'll have to settle for 17 rifle kills. I mean, this is another instance of Michigan State, like, calling Go B out of spawn and then, like, literally just stopping in the pipe because they get smoked or mollied. Flash now comes in. No one there to kind of get flashed. IEPY in a pretty good retake formation. Smoke goes in to stop any scaling. Straylock finds Danny Cool in Monster. On his fast short flank, Blade cannot find Tristan, who flicks and insta headshots peeked through the smoke. How much worse can it get for the Spartans? At least one kill worse as Jaguar is now going up 10-3. Tough scene.
Yeah, this is rough. This is for the Jaguars though. They are roaring right now. They be roaring, looking like a team that can take any challenge, and if the scoreline holds up, the challenge next week will be a tough one.
Is just sending 5 towards B again. Looks like it's actually just gonna be an act. Like, it looks like they might finally just full commit to this rush, and it's the perfect time to do it. Never mind, they're not gonna do it. They had an off in Monster, and he would have gotten rolled over. Blade down to 10 HP with that nade. CMX, he starts wall banging. He's gonna find something. Yep, there it is. That's the kill. The rest of the players in connector go down to Tristan and Gumboot sharing it. And now we have Blade, who got made it down to 10 HP, gets overkilled by the AWP, and I mean,
do anything!
I don't think I could have said anything there that would have been better than those comms. And this is ugly. I don't know what else to say. Michigan State is currently 1-1 gun rounds. They won pistol and the following eco or answer.
I feel like they're. I feel like people have sayings about that, but.
I just got a turkey.
I mean, I know this is like cliche, but like, Michigan State never called even one timeout on either map thus far, I think. To try to sort out their tactics, to try to see, you know, what the group is seeing. Straylock on connector is going to be alerted of that forward crawl, that Molotov. Michigan State actually has garnered a bit of map control here without losing players. Gumboot aggressively peeking through Straylock, trying to find an exit on connector. So Michigan State, it looks like they might be able to get to 4 rounds here. CMX is going to try to shut that down. Amazing flick shot onto Pig. What will the T-side reaction be? 2 players long. 1 player divider. Just now, Aiden is rotating away from B. Flashbang 4 divider thrown. CMX gets a flash from his teammates. Slow crawl up long has just been revealed as the bomb was dropped. CMX heard that. Blade goes down, or Blade takes Tristan down, I should say, and CMX pinched. So Michigan State, they're looking to finally secure a 4th round. They will. Will it be enough to mount a comeback? That'll be based off of really the CT pistol round, I think.
Yeah, 11-4, just like Ancient is the halftime score. This time, though, IBY on the favorite side, which honestly you can still say that Ancient is like 50-50. So,
I mean, for the sake of Michigan State at least showing up in this series, I might, you know, might hope they at least can get this pistol round. IEPY looking to deploy a fast B play. Flashes are going to be bountiful. However, there are CTs all around this bomb site. Danny Cool hits the initial headshot under Big Daddy. Babe Nation finds up one as well. Aiden from ramp trying to hit some shots. Everyone but him seems to be successful in that practice, and this is going to be a Michigan State pistol round. So IEPY, unless Gumby can pull off the impossible, will not be able to secure either pistol on overpass.
Michigan State gonna have to hit a lot more shots and in a good amount of time here, rapid amount of succession, to get these rounds up. That is a good start if they want to have any chance of coming back on this map.
Pretty much no investment here for the T side. Two deagles, a couple flashbangs. It'll be on the deagles to try to find entries. Should be noted the CMX is probably going to be relegated to a Galil in the case of a guy next round for the T side, especially without a bomb plant, which seems very unlikely at this junction. But seems pretty unlikely that IEPY even finds more than a single kill here. Bomb is down playground. Tristan going to retrieve. Invasion spots out big IDA.
I'm so scared.
Should be a free kill for Big Nation here. This is her big IDA knife in the wall. Indeed it will be. CMX in a position to trade perhaps. Tristan will find it instead. Immediately runs down Khan. That would have been spotted on the death cam. And Tristan will indeed be found by Blade. So once again, Michigan State starts their half with a pinch round victory and a very clean anti-eco. This time last half, they lost 5 rounds in a row, so they'll try to prevent that from happening again. No AWPs for either side. CMX left without utility because of his deagle purchase in the last round. Big Daddy A, actually the B defaulter for IEPY this round. Contested shortly will come in. Nice headshot from Big Daddy A, but 2 versus 1 will be 1 from the Michigan State side. Big Nation goes down on the playground push to Gumboot. So man advantage for the Jaguars early on, but there is still an aggressive party lurk in Aiden. He hears Gumboot coming up. Will win the fight. 3 versus 3 now. Pretty much a deathmatch server thus far. Counter smoke being thrown from the CT side. I think that Heaven Smoke was almost thrown to bait out utility, and maybe a second wave is coming. Tristan gonna walk towards connector. CMX with him. Closest A defender is on the A bomb side itself. Sherlock trying to make some space for his team onto B. Rotations being caused. Aiden already into Heaven. That's an A site clear if IEPY can react fast enough. But will they? CMX is actually still in water. I think there was maybe a call that Sherlock wanted to end B there because of how much space he had taken. Should a lot. Tristan a bomb plant. CMX here to cover. Aiden scaling very fast onto Dyson. We'll find the first kill. CMX tagged up a bit and spotted. And will be fragged. Michigan State narrowed the deficit to 4 and are off to a very good start to the CT side.
Yep, they are definitely doing a good job here on the CT side. Much better than their T side early. 3 straight rounds. 11-7 the game. IEPY in a weird position. They will probably half buy this, although I say that, and Tristan immediately 8k's up.
Yeah, I mean, there might be discussion around trying to keep the CT
and now they
low.
Will commit to the force buy.
Definitely Big Daddy only half buying, though. Maybe wants to pick up an off here at some point on this T side.
All 5 players connector are A. Aiden and Babe Nation here to try to stop it. Very quickly up connected. There's no flashbang, though. Aiden couldn't hit a shot, though. Flashbang's now raining over. Aiden anti-flash in time. Gumboot almost goes down in that exchange. Tristan not ready for the op map. This is a very strong op position, especially if no one's pushing long, which currently IEPY has no one. Babe Nation doesn't know that, though, and him peeking long causes his death. Aiden with a double kill, trying to go for the triple, is able to. Michigan State, they're looking alive on the CT half. And it should be noted that IEPY has, with this core, choked at least 2 overpasses. I've witnessed 2 overpass chokes by this team.
Oh boy. Praying on their downfall?
I'm just merely stating historical facts. Forced buy, or I shouldn't say forced buying, kind of a half buy from IEPY. They'll be 100% okay to full buy into the next round. Strelok quickly scaling through connect to the rest of his team in playground. Aiden, that's going to be an absolutely free kill for him. Tristan and Water is maybe a pinch point for this connection player. Indeed, door open. Aiden hit by the door. But will find his kill traded. Babe Nation, we saw him do an entry kill worth of damage in the last round with this AWP map, and he looks to be doing some more damage this round. No one long once again for IEPY, which makes this map position very strong if Babe Nation can trust himself not to be flanked. I don't think he can possibly expect Big Daddy A to be up so far, though. He is checking that corner and finds the kill, so very cerebral there. Not cerebral enough, though. His teammates will make up for that missed shot. Only two rounds separate the teams now. What seems like was so dominant for the IEPY side is now becoming a lot closer than they were probably are comfortable with. AWP thrown over to Gumboot on this T side. BJDA still has $2,300 left in his bank account. BJDA should have bought Gumboot the AWP so that Gumboot could have bought utility here, but what do I know? Looks like Michigan State's a bit confused about how they want to run this long bathroom setup. And I feel like they're taking advantage of that time. Tristan flashed out long and be scaling up. Both CT players in long bathrooms, and that's caused a B rotation. Pig rotating up from B side onto A right now. Going to try to help this triple bathroom setup. Off angle from Danny Cool, who finds Tristan. Bomb long. The rest of his team towards front bathrooms. This is going to be very timing based for both sides. CMX can't possibly know how close he is to Aiden, who finds the first kill. Here's Gumboot's scope. Gumboot, nice shot. Through the wall, finds the kill. Danny Cool finds a double onto Trailock. And the shadow advantage almost collects Gumboot. Big Daddy trying to make space for his team here. Trying to create some chaos. Goes up onto A, flanking long now. And Danny Cool, man, what a round from Danny. A 4K and a crisp double headshot there at the end. Michigan State only one round away from tying it. IEPY, they will deploy a timeout here.
Yeah, a timeout that is much needed. This Michigan State team is looking completely different from the T side. As the IEPY side, it needs to figure something out, or we might be going to Vertigo, which is something that most people probably weren't expecting the way this game is going on the other side.
Yeah, I mean, it just seems like Michigan State's T side was just so out of whack, pretty much getting picked at every opportunity. The executes just were not going through. Every off angle, IEPY was just capitalizing off of with multi-frags. And you can pretty much say the exact same about this half in reverse. Michigan State, in particular, that last round has been the most impressive to me. The B rotation up to make a triple bathroom setup, what seemed to be kind of a pinched situation for them, ends up being a successful round win. Aiden, using the smoke to come up into party. He's going to get pinched here. Just a matter of time. Gumboot forces Aiden off. Sprays through the smoke. Aiden goes down. Now Big Daddy A collects Pig, who is the connector player. That's going to be an open A bomb site until Babe Nation can come up and rotate. The op is here. Now what did the T side decide to do? There's still a minute and 20 seconds left in this round. And they have the whole map to work with. Blade only player for Michigan State, stopping IEPY from heading towards this B-bomb site. And it looks like IEPY is, at the very least, interested in trying to make a water control play happen here. Straylock with the AK. Blade finds him, but is traded by Big Daddy A, and now IEPY exploding towards B. The fastest rotation is Danny Cool. Babe Nation finds Tristan, trying to prevent rotations, but meanwhile, the T side is out and pushing. Danny has a Molotov out. Big Daddy A runs away with his life. Danny Cool trying to get this anti-bomb plant Molotov off, but he's too afraid to throw it. And now it's just going to be a retake. Piece of utility. Babe Nation with the off. That's not going to be an easy gun to retake with. Danny Cool finds Big Daddy A. He was low health. Danny finds another headshot. He's been so impactful in these last two rounds, and Babe Nation trades it. Michigan State, they win the round.
Yeah, that was a 5v3. IPY finding the first two kills, and Michigan State just IPY throws that away, and Michigan State trades all the trades that need to be made. And they've tied this game.
How nervous Danny felt in the last game and even into portions of this game. I think the nerves are gone, and he's actually been gifted the AWP. He has a monster spawn. I would assume that's where he's going to head with it. Looks like the T side isn't going to be heading there fast. He might have a pick opportunity on a Tristan. Jumps across. No early fights, despite the fact that the CT side is pushed into water. So once again, Michigan State with water control. This benefited them in the last round with the early B rotation. Divider Molotov being lined up by CMX. Tristan finds the kill onto Danny, who was AWPing. That is not how that fight is supposed to go. Aiden, who could use an AWP in this exact situation, doesn't need it. Finds Straylock, long-range headshot, Gumboot, trying to get a position to trade. Aiden backpedaling, still winning and wins the fight. Tristan finds a second on the B-bomb side. It's really just a case of who's fragging. Aiden on a double, Tristan on a double. Can he make it a triple? Babe Nation on a barrels off angle, now on the pillar, finds the off angle onto Tristan and sprays on the Big Daddy A. Reloads into CMX's angle. And now a 1v2 for CMX, very winnable. Gonna be able to get bombed down. Pig spotted the head. What is CMX's reaction? Aiden, will he go through the smoke? Pig looking, and both players spraying on CMX. Michigan State has taken the lead. IEPY scoreless in the second half.
Yep, not one T round, making Michigan State's T round looks like paradise. Like it was meant to be, compared to the way IEPY is. They're just not able to win any of these rounds, although they are making them closer. They have a lot of close rounds here, but
well, I've got with a 5-man long play here. Babe Nation with the AWP, they're gonna need a deep flash, not deep enough, but Babe Nation does miss the flick shot. No rotations just yet. Pig now making the crawl up to A. Oh, that's gonna be all the information the CTs need. T's scaling so fast onto this bomb site. There are three CTs just waiting. Tristan going through the smoke. What a play. He finds Babe Nation. Almost flicks onto Aiden. CMX meanwhile finds Pig. Aiden trades onto CMX. Bigger Day onto Truck. It's a 2v2. Tristan's opening through the smoke. This has proved invaluable for IEPY. The chaos it created allows IEPY to get onto the bomb site. Now you have to close it out though. Straylock picks up an AWP but can't find the kill with it. And Blade doubles up with the A1S. Michigan State on to 13 rounds.
Michigan State, once again, Aiden whiffing on Tristan, allowing Tristan to even find one there is incredible, but Michigan State cleans it up in the end, and now 3 rounds away from winning what was thought to be an open and shut case for IEPY.
Yeah, and I mean, I said IEPY has thrown games on this map, and this is currently qualifying as the third throw that I've witnessed if it ends in a Michigan State victory. I wonder what the discussions are from IEPY right now. I mean, Tristan found entries towards B. I wonder if you try to go back to that. Double off setup for IEPY, just trying to find fights that are worth taking. Straylock goes down, and Aiden, he slips the net. He's out. Untradeable. CMX, nothing found con yet. Nadeor for the CT side. That's going to be a lot of information for Danny. Just jumped and cleared it. Aiden's going to use that information to find an angle into short. And it almost seems like they're paralyzed right now. Blade, that was a lot messier than Big Daddy A usually would find on that angle, but we'll find Tristan caught unknowing. Unexpected. Michigan State pivots into a pretty interesting setup here. They have two water, one connector, and one towards A. T-side's going to have to cross water. And into Pig's vision. He finds the first Big Daddy. He does trade. He will fly out monster. There's two smokes on this T-side. One of them surely deployed mid-site. Both players AWPing in this 2v3. Originally a 2v4. Planning in the smoke is Big Daddy A. Not going to be able to be prevented. Aiden spraying through. Alerts Big Daddy of his position. Big Daddy running close and finds the kill. This is very winnable now. 2v2. And Big Daddy doubles up. Danny Cool hook into Monster. Bigetti slips out. This will be a 4K for him. All in this 2 versus 4. Danny smokes. This is not going to be an easy round for Bigetti now. No utility to try to make this easier. The spray through the smoke. Gonna alert Bigetti that this bomb is not being stuck. But M4A1S has been scooped. Bigetti running through the smoke. Danny Cool off the bomb. Hits a headshot and gets back on it. Danny clutching up for Michigan State. 1 versus 2. And that's going to put Michigan State onto 14 round wins. IEPY, it's all falling apart.
Yeah, it is falling apart indeed. Yeah, the double op setup, interesting decision for IEPY. Almost works out for them in the end there. So, Big Daddy was hitting his shots. Unfortunately, Gumbu missed a shot on Danny Cool. And Danny Cool is living up to his name now. And played really well in these last and during this Michigan State streak that they've been having.
Yeah, and I mean, it's literally what? We're at 10 rounds in a row now for the Michigan State side. Tristan very quickly into water. We haven't seen a whole lot of this from IEPY. Quick molly in response. I mean, if you're Tristan at this point, you've got to be like, man, if we had just taken short fast all this time, we probably... I mean, that's actually a good point. We've seen a lot of aggression from Michigan State into this water area. We've yet to see this like a standard molly flashbang take from the Jaguars. And Tristan, he gets wallbanged by Blade. That is... not going to be fun. Pig, wow. He's able to find Bigetti and dink CMX in just a blink of an eye. Meanwhile, aggression from Danny Cool into Monster. Michigan State showing no respect on the CT side any longer. These 10 rounds in a row have been proven a disaster for IEPY. Gumboot spotted, naded. Aiden, going to find the kill. 15-11. Michigan State has won 11 straight rounds. IEPY has completely collapsed.
Yeah, this is not a good sight to see. For a team that we were talking so highly of just moments ago, Michigan State showing their CT side dominance. And
I mean, IEPY was literally gloating in the team chat, saying that they were falling asleep, saying that this was too easy, saying that this was Michigan State's map pick. And here they are, 11 straight round losses. Babe Nation trying to make it 12. Two monster for the CTs. Gumbu just trying to grasp any kind of advantage, and it is not falling into IEPY's hands. Gumbu, 12 HP, will escape. But this is looking over. CMX will find Blade. Molly into barrels. Force Danny Cool to Molly. Nade follows down to 69 HP. Gumbu collected. CMX scaling. This round has become interesting despite how ugly it looked. Not crossing to sight. I think just through Babe Nation's scope. This is where it becomes difficult. Sherlock trying to make space. Peeks into two players, goes down. CMX now needing a 1-3 to keep his team in a map that they were winning 11-4, and it's not happening. Michigan State wins 12 straight CT rounds on Overpass to win map 2 and force Vertigo. Unthinkable scenes.
Unthinkable scenes. That's a good way to put it. That is... oof. That is unfortunate if you're IPY. And now you just have to regroup for Vertigo and not think about it too much and let it be a tilter. That's crazy.
That's my response in general chat. So, I mean, not only do you have to grapple with the fact that you're playing a map 3 for $100 a piece, you now also have to grapple with the fact that you just lost 12 straight rounds after winning 11-4 on CT side. Like, the momentum is dead, the vibes are dead. You have to full reset for this final map of Vertigo. And if you get off to a bad start, there's no saying what could happen. I mean, just imagine how Michigan State must have felt losing map 1 such in a dominant fashion, losing the first half 11-4. I mean, it really did seem like towards the end of that T side that, like, there was just no communication. The emotions just weren't there for Michigan State. And then as they started to pick up CT round after CT round after CT round, you know, the excitement seemed to return. The momentum was on their side, and they never let it go. And now the exact same can be said about IEPY. They need to have a decent start here, or else it's just going to get ugly fast. Vertigo is not nearly as CT-sided as Overpasses either, so even a knife round victory, I'd say, just isn't gonna particularly spur any kind of advantage. Well, at least we got a good one. I was thinking for a while that was just going to be a quick 2-0 and a handshake. But instead, we see maybe the biggest throw I've ever seen from IEPUI. I mean, I've seen some throws, but never 12 rounds in a row after being up 11-4. That is something special. I mean, I think there was only one round in that entire half that Michigan State had to win a clutch. I think Danny's monster 1-2 is the closest IEPUI got the entire half. I think there were some situations where Michigan State had 2 alive, or effectively 2 alive in a 2-1 fight that ended up maybe ending in a 1-1. But I mean, that half, it was just really never close.
Yeah. It was domination.
So moving on to Vertigo, I would expect, at least positionally, Gumboot to be on B, CMX to be on mid, and a combination of Tristan Straylock and Big Daddy A to be handling ramp duties. As far as the T side goes, I don't really know what to expect. Probably a lot of spawn based positions and plays. Waiting on both teams to ready up. IEPUI, I'm sure, taking some time to decompress from that tough loss. Tough might be an understatement. It must also be particularly disheartening for someone like Gumboot, who has such an impressive performance. To end up in a loss. But, I mean, this is where, you know, CMX and Big Daddy A, this is where they need to really step up and show, you know, that they are indeed the fragging leaders of this team. And that, you know, they're essentially why IEPUI has been able to have so much collegiate success over these last few years. The other storyline, I'd say, is I think Straylock ended that game with no more than 8 or 9 kills. I'll go ahead and alt-tab real fast. Yeah, Straylock ended that game, which was a 27-round game, on 7 kills. So definitely an opportunity for Straylock to bounce back and show some impact on this final map of Vertigo. And as soon as the knife round starts, we'll be in official action, as the knife round is impactful. Seems like IEPUI might be utilizing this full 5 minutes in between maps to
IEPUI ready.
Oh, okay. There we go.
The map of the number 3. Shocked we're here, but we're here.
Winner of this knife round will earn the right to start on CT side. Luckily, we are not witnessing knife round cringe. IEPI will win it. CT side start for them. And, certainly, for IEPI's mental sake, I hope that they're able to take a pistol round here, because otherwise they would be losing 13 rounds in a row. And we'll keep that count going for as long as it's needed. Michigan State. Looks like they're headed towards at least a B stairs control start. Once again, we're not seeing any kind of fast pistol round play. But here come the flashes and here comes the scaling up the B stairs with the bomb. Player Elbow and CMX, player Default and Gumboot retreats to generator. CMX springs into action from Elbow, unexpected, finds two kills, gets back to cover, jiggling, trying to bait out shots, will find Blade, and Gumboot swings in for the fourth. So IEPI, they finally stop the Michigan State spree at 12, and they will win the Vertigo pistol round without losing a single player. That is exactly what IEPI needed, and CMX, four kills. Good start for him.
Exactly what the doctor ordered. IEPI not losing a single player on that surround. Simple bait and switch on the B bomb site with a double side swing on A and quick rotates. And a much needed round for the mental state.
Oof.
Wow, they ate that name.
Yeah, there's only a $300 investment into this round for Michigan State. It's the P250 of Babe Nation. This should be a very easy cleanup for CMX and Straylock. Hopefully, Straylock gets most of the kills, as the MP9 will collect $300 extra per kill. But, wow, Aiden is... What are your thoughts on Aiden's play here, Jackass DDD?
I do something like that when I win the pistol round on an eco. But with a Glock, that's... pretty cringe, as his whole teammates, all of his teammates get slaughtered, but hey, he's still got this Glock. Oh, he is playing this round out, I'll tell you what.
This is maybe the biggest do-nothing, do-something challenge I've ever seen.
That play was sick. Anyways.
That was close. I thought he was going to clutch that for a second.
We are going into round three. First buy round. We'll see what Michigan State comes up with.
Ump theory for Big Daddy A. Well, only two early ramp for Michigan State, so probably not going to be trying to make any kind of fast plays. Top ramp lurk smoke. You don't see this a whole lot. And no effort to kind of push through from Michigan State, at least in this round. Big Daddy A, however, pushed down short. Or side, I should say. Molly on the right side to force Pig off that corner. Now Big Daddy A finds himself into his own corner. That smoke was trying to land on the Molotov. That might have been a bit deeper than is optimal. However, kind of gives a, you know, an effective amount of lurk space to Big Daddy A. Unless Pig can find a one-way there. I kind of liked how this has ended up. Meanwhile, Babe Nation, he's quite far into a mid-lurk here, and CMX is only covering the boost. Daddy A going to use a smoke to get himself out. And Baby Nation will indeed find Straylock on that midler. AK-47 at long range. It's good enough. Big Daddy A going to back up this ramp aggression. The ump is not going to be particularly useful at that range. Flashbang in for Tristan to retake. No one spotted. Meanwhile, Gumboot still playing this back triple, or back double, I should say, off angle. I would not be surprised to see Gumboot try to utilize his smoke grenade soon. Only 40 seconds left in this round. Bomb, however, headed towards B as well on a walk. Gumboot, with only 30 seconds left, I'm shocked Gumboot hasn't deployed a smoke yet. If Gumboot dies without using the smoke grenade, this is going to be a disaster. He spotted out Blade, comes up to sight, and there's just no smoke. No smoke thrown. Tristan trying to make a retake happen mid, will collect. CMX finds one as well. Behind generator, 10 bullets, is able to collect one. Aiden behind double stack fighting.
5 seconds.
We'll
five
find
seconds.
CMX.
No time.
Ow. Well, I mean, I was making a big deal out of the smoke grenade stalling time, but it looks like Michigan State just did it to themselves.
CMX's Molly there also did a good job at delaying the second wave of push on suicide there, and yeah, and then the delayed, the labored fights that Michigan State had to take just took too much time. And Michigan State kind of shot themselves in the foot there because they got the opening frag, which weren't able to scale.
Yeah, and we're seeing a default from Michigan State that you don't see a whole lot, and that they're putting two ramp and two B with one mid. I'm much used to seeing just three ramp, one B. We'll see if they keep that up. This was a very clean go from IEPY, and they are up 4-0. A very good start considering how bad the last half went for them. It's also the second time we've seen that top line lurk spot for Michigan State.
4-0 going to round 5. The Krieg, the Baby Nation, big Krieg guy.
Same default, I think. No, actually 3-ramp this time, 3-ramp. Pig gonna op up, try to find a kill onto side. This is an interesting boost. Big Nade is definitely gonna get himself spotted out. That nade though just did so much damage, and Big Nade uses that timing to sneak out. Big Nade spraying through the smoke, Pig down to 6 HP. No armor was the sacrifice for that AWP. Big Daddy A throws a smoke for bottom side, gives himself a little bit of space. Not quite as deep as he probably would like. That Molotov, he's going to force Big Daddy A out. Only 50 HP to make this happen, and it's not going to happen. Tristan now alone a bombsite player for the Jaguars. CMX and Strelok on a double stack in middle. Michigan State, despite having 5 alive, do have quite a large amount of health missing. IEPY does have incendiaries and nades to kind of chip down even further if they need to. Tristan now trying to make his way into side. CMX and Strelok still posted on mid. T-side still 4 towards ramp. Aiden spots out Tristan's shoulder with an aid in his hand. Full X coming in with flash aside, with Molly sight, with smoke sight. Tristan trying to make something happen. Aiden trying to distract. Tristan's still alive, still a nuisance. Strelok getting shot through the smoke. Tristan trying to balance so many angles. He finds one, but not able to escape. Blade quick trade there. Strelok sprang through the smoke, almost finds Blade, and all Michigan State are so low, but there's just no HEs from IEPY. They do find Danny Cool. Pigs off, finds the jump up player. CMX finds a trade and will find the last onto Pig. The AWP will be collected as well. And IEPY, that was a bit scary, but they find a fifth round.
Yeah. IEPY doing a good job there after the exit comes in. A lot of util damage done with the nade, and just being in positions to trade their teammates. When the plant goes in, swinging on the side player, as well as getting defaulter, as well as a whiff shot on the op that maybe could have won that round at 1v2.
Still going to purchase and do this round. Our Michigan State, the bomb plan allows that. B-pop incoming. There are two players towards this B-bomb site. Blade is not looking. CMX finds the first. Can't find the second. Good trade from Aiden. Gaboot now going to throw in Nate to fall away. Aiden down to 19. Babe Nation finds a pick and a second on his mid lurk. And this is now looking like Michigan State's first round win. Big Daddy cuts off that flank. What is the call from Michigan State? Do they continue to hit this B-bomb site? Looks like they will. Flash is thrown. Danny Cool space taken. Big Daddy on an off angle defaults. Won't win the fight. And that is a spray down onto the IEPY players. Now, Gumboot did, because of Gumboot jumping around that corner, the off falls off the map, which I guess is kind of a win.
Small victory. But Michigan State is going to be happy. IEPY was in a position to get, they played a double B stack. I think CMX took an early fight there that allowed him to get easily traded after they were all looking at Blake, Gumboot. But 5-1 now.
Throwing like a counter lurk smoke here. Big Daddy Aiden lurking down, finds the first, and Aiden trying to get into the gap between both smokes. Danny Cool, make a play. Oh wow, Blade. He finds Big Daddy. That was definitely through a smoke. I don't know why I didn't say that. Tristan and Strelok now, last players remaining on A, going to attempt a boost. the action is pivoting over towards B. Gumboot on this elbow angle. He still has a smoke and a Molotov, but only the smoke will be helpful if they molly elbow. CMX playing mid on an off angle. Won't be nearly as fast as he needs to be to get back towards B if needed. And this execute is lining up right now for the T side. Babe Nation already boosted into danger. Utility being thrown to CMX now. Trying to make a rotation. Gumboot, stuck elbow, just jumps out instead of trying to play his life. And now, what will the reaction be from IUI? Default molly being thrown. It's going to, at the very least, delay a bomb plant. But I mean, if you're IUQ, I think you have to consider a save. 3 versus 4. CMX.
I think they're going to go in on the slow.
Tristan going to flash. First kill found. CMX is really going to scale with the flashbang. CMX finds two, actually. Can't find the third. Strela goes down. Tristan.
It's not planted for. Well. It's not planted for the ramp player.
Wow.
Because of the default molly. He's got to come up. Yeah. Michigan State not waiting for the default molly to go out, doing the need to rush that plant. Doesn't plant for the Sayers player, and CMX finding, what was it, 3 or 4 on the round?
Yeah,
on the retake. Yeah. That is a Michigan State round that they should not be losing.
Yeah, CMX just basically up. Working off of that smoke fading. Finds two. And then finds the third there at the end.
Up to 14 now. He is playing well in this vertigo.
Yeah, despite the fact that Michigan State is down 6-1, we really haven't seen much changing from their default. Aiden not able to even purchase a smoke this round means that they won't throw that top rank smoke. Babe Nation really, I think, has to be the difference in this round with the AWP. There's just not enough util for the T-side to have a sustained default here. This smoke from Tristan is atrocious, unequivocally.
He just kind of bounced.
Oh, Babe Nation. The off. What? What a shot from Babe Nation. From Tristan's POV, that looked absurd. And, I mean, we've seen this one before. Find picks A, find map control A, walk back B, and execute.
Yeah, with Big Daddy A down.
Well, there comes the utility. Gumboot on this back double off angle. Babe Nation quick again. He found an entry at A, finds an entry at B. I mentioned he had to be the focal point to win this round, and he has been that. CT's going to opt into a save here, it looks like. So Michigan State off the Babe Nation's off exclusively win this round.
Yeah, there's two quick flicks from Babe and IUPUI. A rare save from them, but a save nonetheless. Michigan State gonna find a much needed second.
Michigan State, their economy isn't fantastic, but it looks like they are going to go on a bit of a hunt here. Molly might dissuade them. Look at that. That Molly landed on like a ledge here or something. So, 5 alive, round to win for Michigan State. IUPUI, their economy is not looking good here. This might end up being a 6-3 scoreline or even a 6-4 if IUPUI can't pull through with this round win. Tristan forces into this round. Gumboot the only... No, he's actually going to buy up into it at the last second as well. Quick nade from CMX might tag Babe Nation a bit. Yeah, 4 HP. Meanwhile, 3-player touchdown from Michigan State. I think that, once again, top ramp punch block thrown from Aiden. Choosing not to play around at this round. Big Idea has really seen absolutely no contest into fast yellow this entire half. Gonna throw a bottom yellow smoke. And Aiden wins the fight onto Straylock, so round once again opened at A. We've seen late Bs pretty much every time after this has happened. Michigan State switches this up. Would not be surprised. Big Daddy A, mollied out of Henny. This really does seem to be Michigan State's default flowchart. Wait out bottom ramp smokes, molly top Henny, and start to walk up with that information. Big Daddy A. King in yellow. Babe Nation will be the first one to contact. Big Daddy whiffing the spray. Babe Nation makes good on it. And Pig gooses up Tristan. Rotations trying to be made. C-Max, he is sandbags. Danny Cool throwing a molly in. C-Max swinging out, finds that kill. Aiden jumps up, revealing his position to C-Max. He's now trying to get into side. Babe Nation goes out to Tristan. 3 versus 3 now. Gobo with the molly to stop the default plant. It's been thrown. Boost for C-Max. 3 versus 3 still. Oh, Pig spawned out. C-Max can't find the spray at all. Both teams have one player quite low. Tristan finds a kill. C-Max onto sandbags, and Tristan doubles up with just 27 HP entering that bomb sites, I think.
Yep. Once again, I feel like doing while coordinating when the bomb plant goes down to just take those fights while they stick the plant, because Michigan State has not shown the fake any of those plants. Michigan State, though, getting the opening two frags, having a 5v3, and just not able to take the A bomb site either. Team X, once again, is 16-2 to start this game out, as Blake misses a Molotov on B, and so does Tristan. So that's $1,200 down the drain at the V-bomb site. And honestly, both of the nades missed too, so that is 1,800. So
what's interesting here is IPUI did not choose to fight a ramp, and Aiden chose to fight with his Lurk Smoke. So a lot of free information here for Michigan State. However, they did lose Babe Nation on a very aggressive mid lurk, walking into two players.
Aiden not wanting to stop. He just heard a jump up noise. He knows one was there.
I mean, Aiden could just as easily sneak up on Big Daddy A here. Sherlock at any point could rotate elevator, though, which could make things difficult. Big Daddy A walking into CT does spot on Aiden's shoulder, and Aiden does not win the fight. 5v3 advantage now for IEPY. A lot of information gained. The bomb is at a ramp, and with this setup in place, and with how much util IEPY still has left over, this is not going to be easy for Michigan State. Scaling onto the bomb site. Molly's raining in everywhere. Flash is raining in everywhere. Pig sticks the plan, but he'll immediately have to evacuate and go down. Danny on all angle finds one, but can't find anything else. And now Blade side. The Yeti Egg goes down, but nothing else. IEPY onto an 8-2 scoreline.
Well, once again, IEPY, all three maps have shown that they've been off to a strong start, but unlike both maps, we don't know if they'll be able to finish. So, IEPY playing well so far. Aiden having the lurk play, but just misses his timing, and that's CSGO. It's a game of timings, and
yeah,
unfortunately, he lost his battle.
It was a decision as to whether to greed and try to take the space without a smoke or to just smoke. That nade might do massive damage. Only a little bit on the Ape Nation. They waited it out, and now they will start their crawl. This is a kind of a coordinated decision to say, okay, we're not getting ramp early. Let's try to put some early pressure on mid. And they really haven't revealed their position in doing so. However, Straylock and CMX, if they can get to their setup they want to run in D, CMX is going to hop on top. This is not going to be an easy angle to clear, especially if a flashbang does not come in. Connector has been cleared with Aiden's boost. What is going to be the call? Will they smoke? Will they flash? Or will they just swing into mid? Right now, it looks like they're just going to take the fight. CMX is J-Lock. That's exactly what they want. That's the smoke, though. Molly being thrown, but it's actually been extinguished. Not deep enough. Now a second one flies in. Stop the connector crawl. B fights being taken onto Tristan. Fights mid, spraying through the smoke chaotically. Tristan goes down on suicide, and now Straylock flashed off. Push coming in through CT. There are players flying in every which direction. Blade finds one. Babe Nation finds one. 2v2. Blade now just 1v2. Quick headshot onto CMX, and he needed that. Only 15 HP. And Big Daddy A, he found one in this round, needs two. Blade needs four. And Michigan State, they could use every bit of this clutch. He seems pretty convinced that Big Daddy A is connector, however. The Jaguars made the rotation to CT, and that will be the round-winning rotation. 9-2 lead now for the Jaguars. Michigan State, they need to turn this around quick.
Yeah. Honestly, shocked that Michigan State was able to get that down to even a 1v1. I felt like they were really trying to force that mid-pop, mid-B split to work. And, like, I guess the IEPY missed shots. Because like it felt like they were trying to force something that wasn't there, and they still almost won that round. So I was honestly shocked by that. But IEPY wins it nonetheless. Another mid rush, this time a little more quicker with pistols.
Wow, CMX completely rolled over, but there are two players B for IEPY. And then Molly so quick. Gumboot as well with a nade takes down Big. Blade for from these stairs. We'll collect gumboot though. Tristan finds one on connector. Getting pushed from two different directions. This is a questionable movement decision from Tristan. Punished, and Agent will take down Big Daddy A. Straight lock. Both of his opponents are lit, but does he know that? That nade, if he throws a default, could be impactful, but he's going to take the space instead. Aiden with the M4A1S. Blade with the M4 as well. Quick peek onto Straylock, and that's going to be Michigan's third round. The Eco Rush was enough to finally break the IUPUI defense.
Yeah, that is wild that just running out with Tech 9 just wins on that round. Straylock throws the nade there with... easily win that, and IPY is gonna be on double save, so they're gonna force here, and if these pistols don't do any work, I mean, we could see a 9-6 half.
Wow, very quickly running towards this move. It's like Gumboot falls into three players ready to catch him, and this is not going to be any sort of hesitation. This is going to be a quick scaling on a B, and I think CMX has made the decision to save. He is on a 5-7 in armor. Tristan also on a 5-7 in armor. I guess he was just falling back to 3 retake utility or something. Straylock on the flank does find Pig. Tristan may try to make a play with his flashbang. That nade. Wow. Quite a bit of damage. Flashbang is good on the blade though. Tristan finds the first. Flashes from the T side now. 3 versus 3. Straylock and Chris both lurking through Z-Con here. Straylock on the USP goes down. And this is likely going to be all she wrote for this round. CMX may try to find some exits to Babe Nation with the AWP. Spray is not good though. And IEPY, they're going to be on a save here. So Michigan State, they are making a half out of this.
They are, and like I said, they can make this 9-6. They like what they see over at the B bomb site, and they have consistently hit B or mid. So
yeah, and I don't think we've seen them win a round on A.
No.
Once again, quick B push from both sides. And it is once again weighted towards Michigan State. Nice one beat from Gumboot. He's on 100 health and a defuse kit. Babe Nation down to 15 HP in the exchange as well. He is going to be taken down. The bomb, however, doesn't seem to be in any real danger. Unless he sticks around. Finally rotating away now. Aiden and Pig are in very forward positions. Particularly Pig is already in CT spawn. It's going to be hard for Gumboot to expect. Nice behalf from Big Daddy A, and the trade comes in, so that play worked. The distraction was solid. Aiden getting into the kind of off angle. Nice Gumboot, and now it's on to Tristan at a 1 versus 2. He finds the first. He has armor. Gumboot had a kit if needed. Tap comes in. Aiden forced to come up and fight. Can Tristan win it? Flicks down and wins at a 1 versus 2 for Tristan. An amazing round from both him and Gumboot.
Full house from the two. Huge, I would say a huge crucial round there. Securing 10 and putting them in a good spot to potentially get 11 here. We see 11-4. All three games, 11-4 halves. That'd be crazy. Oslo, 3 kills, having an ancient performance. Mollied out.
Same goes for B. IEPY, I really like how they've handled the CT side. They've realized that like no early pressure is being put on A ramp, and they have just made the effort to put 2 stacks towards both mid and B when needed. And once again, this is coming true. Michigan State is not doing anything but hitting this B bomb site. Gumboot playing this back double stack off angle. Babe Nation shouldn't be able to see this, and Gumboot will very quickly call out the utility being thrown. Counter smokes for the Jaguars, and T side currently walking up trying to commit. Very aggressive position from Tristan. He finds one. Gumboot finds one. Gets killed by a blind Babe Nation. Tristan still dancing around double stack. CMX with support. Not quick enough to save Tristan there, but great trying to be attempt. Not going to happen. 2 versus 2 now. Strelak misses the off shot. Pig punishes, and now this is looking winnable for Michigan State. 2 versus 1, favoring them, and Big Daddy A goes down. What a weird collapse from IEPY there at the end, but nonetheless, a 10-5 half. CMX ends it with 22 kills, completing the server by 8 at the minimum. Aiden,
yeah,
on the other side with 12.
That's a round that IFU I should be winning. They had the quick rotates and they just lost their fights trying to make weird smoke aggression plays. Tristan's worked out with Gumboot, but then after that, like, the extra aggression there by CMX got him killed. Is we'll probably see a B rush here. Indeed we will.
Smokes and flashes. Wow, Babe Nation completely clotheslined by Big Eddie's block, and now the smokes are in and the site is taken. Aiden getting sprayed through the smoke as well. There is a kit on Pig, which makes this retake certainly a consideration. Aiden trying to stop this Midler from having impact. Once the smoke fades, the actual fight will begin, and the player to keep an eye on is Pig. He has the smoke in the kit. He's the most important to keep alive, and he's already fallen. This is looking like an IUPI pistol round victory. Aiden able to collect two, but not before he goes down, and Gumboot finalizes that 11th round for IUPI. Only, what, 5 rounds away now from securing $100 apiece in a spot in the quarterfinals.
Yep, just a simple B rush. Excellent post plants. Not much to say there. Michigan State not buying anything. Absolute zero money invested for this mid stack.
Yeah, looks like Tristan and Gumbo were ready for a mid rush. Mid stack now being pivoted towards the A bomb site. Thanks for taking their time with this one. Don't want to lose any guns for lack of diligence. Blade, the last remaining mid player, going to maybe have a gap here. Nope. Smoke lands. Look at a farming towards the A-bomb site, but the main action headed towards B. As Tristan is invading CT spawn, there is a CT lurking in these mid smokes. That's Danny Cool. He finds CMX, collects the AK, trying to find a second, but won't be able to. And that's going to be the round win for the Jaguars. 12-5. And Michigan State desperately needs this next gun round. To save here, except for the $300 you're preventing them from earning for killing you. All right, first taste of Michigan State CT gun around defense. And it's an important one. Not a whole lot of utility had on the Spartan side, but enough to make do for sure. Ramp smoke being lined up and thrown. IEPY looking to make some damage happen on the side. CMX into the one-way smoke. Too far to the right, though. He went too far to the right. That's not a one-way if you go that far. He gets punished. Bit of a misplay from the IEPY leader. Lock in place to line up a one-way smoke. Falls into place. Meanwhile, Tristan fighting on the B bomb site with a default defender. CT is really showing no inclination of fighting onto ramp here. Blade likely to be mollied out here. Smoke deployed. Aiden has a smoke of his own, gonna deploy it onto Crane. Is there flash support for this sandbags player? There is not. Closest flashbang is middle. At this point, you gotta wonder if they're gonna leave him out to dry. It's a second Molotov on Gumboot. Gonna deploy it now. And Blades, guys, he has no choice but to fight. Aiden fighting with him. Gumboot collects one. Aiden collects two. The IPY there, not looking good at the start. This gun round, today he lives with just 1 HP. Tristan going to bear the burden of this clutch. Aiden, wow, finally goes down to Tristan's molly after collecting 4 kills on the round. Michigan State's savior on this one. A They get a 1 HP, 16 seconds left. Danny Cool and Babe Nation stand in the way. Any attempt at a bomb plane here likely to be contested. Indeed it will be. Babe Nation not able to prevent the bomb from being planted, which will mean $800 each for IUPUI, but round still won for Michigan State, and bleeding stopped.
Yep, Aiden finding four there, using Blade essentially as bait, swinging off his contact as he gets double mollied, finding two early, and then even fighting through the flames before he burns to a crisp, but his job was done. He sacrificed his life for the cause. Michigan State's sixth round. We might see a fast B play here.
Early size buff for Gumboot. Looks like it might just be a fast ramp play.
Oh, ramp.
This could get ugly really fast if IUPUI isn't able to play anti-flash. There's actually no one side. There's no one side for Michigan State. I don't know if this was a miscommunication or a bad spawn, but IUPUI has scaled up the ramp so fast here. Right side smoke being thrown by Tristan. Left side being lined up for Big Daddy A. Flashes as well.
Right side is not good.
Aiden fighting. He's got a double already. He got four in the last round. Indeed, right side has a massive gap. That smoke from Tristan is not good, and despite the early map control, only one kill found. Aiden, is that another 4K for Aiden on ramp defense? It was.
That is eight kills in the last two rounds.
I mean, if you're IUPUI at this point, you immediately have to be discouraged about heading towards that A bomb site. Every time you've tried, Aiden has gotten four kills. That was also a very good example of how even just not having a top self-boost Molotov can cause so much damage.
And now we'll see a fast B on another half buy.
Yeah, there's gonna be a molly already thrown. Smoke to put it out. Big Daddy A and Gumboot scaling up of Babe Nation and Danny Cool finding all of the kills except for the once Tristan. But the Tech 9 spam delivers. Gets up an AK as well. Has a flashbang of his own. I wouldn't be surprised to see him toss that down to Straylock to try to flash him in. Blade is on the flank, but wary of flank watchers. Tristan lining up a flashbang. Pig not going to be affected. Tristan finds the entry. Straylock not ready for the default player. Swinging around. So chaotic. This USP has been opened. The Glock is out. The Deagle is out. What is going on? The flank just now arriving will finally put an end to that madness. IUPUI with a pretty decent force buy without the bomb plant. I think they would have liked a little bit more there.
Yep, they would, but they will get a full buy here. 12-8 scoreline, Michigan State, four rounds away from tying. Michigan, or IUPUI, four rounds away from winning.
Doesn't look like Michigan State's going to have any spawn issues this time. Big Daddy A this time going to be the one to enter the one way. I don't love IUPUI's lineup for this one-way smoke. It doesn't go deep enough. Yeah, I mean, Big Daddy A completely missed the one-way that round. That wasn't even a one-way. He just completely missed it. These ramp protocols for IUPUI are not looking good to start this half. Somebody give Big Daddy A some more server time. Work smoke lined up for Straylock, immediately followed by the CTs throwing bottom ramp of their own. Boost for the B site player does net some damage, but not a kill. Also net some rotation. Aiden already rotating over towards the B bomb site, as well as Blade making rotation to mid. Pig the only remaining A ramp player, and that's where the focus is right now for the T side. Walking up is Straylock. Gumboot by his side. Pig on an off angle. Any amount of overfeed will cost him. Straylock finds it. And full X2 coming in. That molly is way too deep.
Ooh.
Gumboot hits the shot. Not Aiden. Every time Aiden's been on the bomb sites, he's gotten four. This time not there, and he gets fragged. IUPUI find 13 unless a miracle happens. Babe Nation, one versus four. Still looking to go for it, it looks like. Gumboot goes down with CMX quickly swinging and trading. Michigan State, they're broke.
Michigan State is broke. Aiden all the way down to 1650. We should still see a half buy though. Actually, two of them have the force, but force buying here would ultimately give up match point. And well, they're gonna put this one out.
I thought I saw a Famas. Yeah, it's been tossed over to Blade. Once again, this is not a one-way smoke, we got EA. This is trash. Any cool pushing up mid. Had a shot on Tristan there, and now, oh, Tristan finds two quick ones. Out of 3 HP, but that should very quickly make this round unwinnable for Michigan State. Blade looking to answer that, finds Gettier, but Babe Nation on a B aggro push gets collected. 2 versus 4. There are low players, must be noted, for IEPY, but it's unlikely that that will change the outcome of this round. Michigan State, they could really use this AK-47 on Blade to have a shot in the next round. Otherwise, it's going to be 15-8. Well, certainly. IEPY on the cusp. After the overpass throw, they are on the cusp. Qualifying for quarterfinals and making $100 apiece. Blades saved AK being pursued. CMX spotting him out. Spinlock caught off guard a bit.
Hello!
And Tristan gets collected as well. So Blade saves the AK and finds 4 kills in the process.
Thank God this is the guy's last season. His last season. Holy fuck, dude. I'm so done with this guy, bro.
Okay.
Michigan State forced into this again.
Yeah, they are.
They do not want to give up match point, but this is not a goodbye. Just banking on a boost here. IEPY is diligent in their ramp take. This is going to be ugly. Should be noted that B stairs was taken. Babe Nation into that corner. Bottom side smoke being deployed. This is where you'd want to throw the one way that IEPY threw earlier, but Straylock is nowhere to be found, and I don't know if anyone else knows the lineup. Oh wow, Aiden's just swinging. He's going to move down to 47.
He didn't swing. He shot through yellow.
Oh,
he is
the gaps in the yellow smoke. Okay.
He is using the yellow gaps. It's cringe, bud.
Boost is still up for Michigan State. Oh, that barrel took an adventure there.
They just dropped out of it.
Wow. They dropped out exactly when they would have had an opportunity to find kills. Babe Nation in the corner? Or yeah, she just pushed the past Sherlock there. Aggression working out in the favor of Spartans. Only 40 seconds left in this round. IPY just now scooping the bomb bottom ramp. A execute seems inevitable.
Oh, Tristan is in CT spawn right now.
Oh. He's been spotted by Aiden! He's got to be living, and Blade finds the kill. No right side smoke for IEPY, and it is a disaster. Team kills aplenty. CMX, 1 versus 4, finds the first. They're likely to get the bomb down. They're unlikely to win. Finds a quick catch on a Babe Nation. 8 only on 1 HP. This is looking possible now. Oh, well... Wow, CMX escapes to side as well. That smoke was only for side. It's not going to smoke ramp, but Danny Cool will find CMX on the rotation. 9 rounds accomplished for Michigan State, and the force by, the desperate force by, works out.
Yeah, I they played a 3A2B setup. They had no one mid, and that's why Aiden was constantly checking towards the end there, but... Yeah, Tristan missing an opportune timing. He was a little bit quicker. He was able to get a little bit quicker on that. He finds Blade and opens up that A-bomb site, but unfortunately, the timing goes in the Michigan State's favor, and 14-9 now.
2 CTs here to receive this mid-slash B-rush. You said there was no one mid last round.
Yeah.
That is definitely going to be a big factor here. They're flying through the mid-connector. Danny Poole getting... completely surrounded. He finds 2. Babe Nation left to pick up the pieces today and not ready for the second player. Babe Nation, wow, I think he just got a little bit too ambitious. CMX was searching for a gun there and instead, Straylock will find a kill. Nade flying in for default. Back generator. Straylock's gonna need a quick headshot onto one of these players to stay alive. Pre-fire's attempted.
This is almost certainly going to come down to CMX trying to clutch out from default. Flash is thrown, peaks, mage go on down. CMX finds one, finds two, just one more to go. He has body armor. Aiden, the leader of Michigan State, is able to clutch it. Keeps the team in it, despite the economic damage done.
Very close round there. The two stars of each team in the 1v1 there. Aiden comes up top this time, 14-10. But Michigan State's money is low. If IPY...
Aiden going on his 6th year of collegiate Counter-Strike. Will he make it out of the slums? Find out next time on your 7th year of college.
CMX adding years of college trade. Went from 6 to 7 real quick.
Pretty cool. Lucky to be alive. Big Daddy missing that off shot. Quickly falls back. It's the first time we've seen just 1B in a long time. And almost wasn't the benefit of IPY. Quick molly for default. So a lot of pressure being put on the B bomb site. Counter flash is literally just being held right now for Pig to help out this B bomb site player. But no commit just yet for IPY. Big Daddy is still actually towards ramp. Smoke's being lined up for the IPY site. Tristan goes down to Bay Bastion's AWP. I think Tristan dinked him through the box. Wasn't enough to find the kill. Gets a quick rotation onto B. Gumboot scaling up very quickly. That was an amazing flashbang for the Jaguars. It's helped them scale onto the bombsite. Gumboot traded, but bombsite taken. Bay Bastion with a little bit of a gap here. No right side gen smoke. And Nade won't be able to collect that flashbang. Also not good enough. And finally go down 3 versus 3. This is an impactful round for Michigan State. They need this round win. The Lord Smoke being thrown. Blade, if AWP finds Sraylock. Now, Big Eddie and CMX, these are exactly the people you want in this situation. CMX finds the first and the second. Blade on 7 HP with the AWP. Finds CMX, now needs to find Big Daddy A. Does Big Daddy know he's lit? He doesn't. The AWP is out. And Blade switches to the AK. One missed shot is all Michigan State needs to win this round. The kit is on Blade. This should be plenty of time for the defuse. He doesn't know where the bomb is, though. And Big Daddy A, no scopes, though! And Blade... He can't find the bomb. Is there enough time?
I think there is. Yeah.
He's got it.
Oh, no.
7 HP clutch switches to the AK and dumps his entire utility kit and wins the round. Big Daddy Ace, no scope, just misses. The decision to not play in default there almost nets IEPY the victory because Blade's entire game plan was smoking the bomb and defusing. And when he couldn't find the bomb, Big Daddy A basically had a free shot onto him, but he was just not ready.
One thing to note is that I don't know if he was like adrenaline, but Blade didn't pick up an op. So CT side doesn't
have. Oh, late flashbang collects Big Daddy A, and Aiden finds the kill. Not before taking quite a bit of damage though. Now the mid lurk activates for the IEPY side. Tristan lining up a smoke. Danny Cool up on Khan, getting a rotation now from Pig over to B. Michigan State, this is exactly how you'd want to play out this round. That molly is going to force the T's to separate. Babe Nation looking for anything stairs, but the entire push is coming from mid. Pig is great. The smoke finds one, but traded. Gumboot now on connector. Here's a player CT. Doesn't respect Babe Nation on A, on sorry, on B peeking so wide. And Australock in this exact same situation. Gumboot was in. Jumping up is Danny Cool, and he finds the headshot. IEPY likely to be forced onto a save. Michigan State, they are pulling it back just like they did on Overpass. 14-12, likely to be 14-13.
Yep, this is starting to get a little bit scary if you're an IEPY fan, as they'll be forced to save here. Nerves is...
Wow, Michigan State, first time out in the entire series. Maybe an indication that they're finally feeling pressure or something.
This is coming down to the wire. They're gonna call two even.
I wonder if somebody had to pee. I mean, there is exclamation point pause, right? That they could have accessed as well.
Yes.
So, we've seen the Eco Force by mid-rush workout for the Jaguars. That's typically not something you can get to work twice in a single half. And, I mean, the purchase up from here on the Jaguar side is just so minimal. Looks like it's just going to be a default in hopes of finding maybe a single kill on one lifelike player. And Fade Nation full commits to that spray inexplicably.
CMX is AFK. Okay, it's back.
We all get a little service on the table sometimes. Anyway, Blade in middle, rotating. Trying to help his B side out. I mean, the panic from Big Nation is not going to actually be punished as Ace finds a double and a quad on the ramp spray down. CMX finally on AFK will come out and find the trade. How's the smoke to work with? This right side smoke could give him enough space to make this a winnable round. That one way smoke can make things difficult though. Right side smoke is deployed indeed. A minute left. Means that the CTs can't full commit to any kind of side stack. CMX has made his way upside. Blade seems ready for it, but CMX likewise is ready for that fight. Takes up Blade through the wall, but not without sustaining some damage himself. Off angle for Pig, not good enough. CMX is fast, and he's fast to get the second as well. This could be absolute disaster for Michigan State. 30 seconds left. Danny, will he be coaxed out by that fake? It looks like he wanted to for a second, but CMX now revealing his case. One tap onto Danny.
You're him!
The tech Save 9 from bottom fuck. Ramp trade onto Aiden. I mean, imagine being Aiden that round. You get 4 kills on a spray down on Eco on ramp. The last player alive has a tech 9, and then that AK-47, just 1v4 is following.
Wow, that is a... That's a tilting round if you're Michigan State, if you're Aiden. That's an amazing booster round for the IUPUI side. No mid. Once again, they're doing the 3-2 setup. Tristan falls victim early.
Babe Nation, a little bit of a redemption for that last round. The commit to the spray is ultimately what opens up the round for IUPUI last time.
Cool. Straight like with the mid wall bang on Blade side. Got him down 38 with an AK. The mid-ladder wall bang.
Yeah. So Gumboot's actually full lurked up danger here. It looks like IUPUI is posturing for a kind of a contact play. Aiden in place with the AWP. He'll be the one flashed. His teammate default currently anti-flash. That's Babe Nation. There is only one... there's two flashbangs. That's going to be the only one that's going to be thrown, though. Babe Nation activates, but can't hit anything. And now Gumboot scaling so fast. This could be it. This could be the round win and the map win for IUPUI. But Pig gets two with the MP9 running through, and now it's all onto Danny Cool. 1v2. Has to do it to keep his team in it. Big Daddy A, close generator. He'll hear any drop. CMX caught out by the drop, but Big Daddy A wins it for his team, 16-12. Michigan State looks so poised to make that comeback, and CMX with a tech 9, 1v4s. 36 kills for CMX and the decider. And I mean, I said it coming in. If you're CMX and if you're Big Daddy A, this is the map to kind of prove you belong and prove your team belongs in quarterfinals, and CMX did prove it. Not only across the one round, but also across the game. What a series by those two teams. Michigan State definitely put up a fight. Considering they were down 4-11 on overpass, to actually pull it to a third map and make it as close as 16-12 is impressive. But not enough. They will leave the Face It Collegiate 2023 season without any prize money.
Yep, a bottom finish for the Spartans. As IUPUI moves on to the quarterfinals. Elite 8. Most likely with a date with Northwood. I haven't checked. I'm assuming
Northwood has already beat Florida. Okay. I'll go ahead and check. Yeah, Northwood won 16-7 on Vertigo and 16-4 on Ancient. So it looks like Northwood and IUPUI share map pools.
Yep.
I mean, Northwood banned Overpass. IUPUI likely to ban Inferno like Florida did. And then Florida banned Nuke while Northwood banned Mirage. I mean, I would not be surprised to see these exact same three maps be played from Northwood beating Florida to Northwood playing IUPUI. So if you're
if you're Straylock, if you're CMX, if you're Gumboot, if you're Tristan, and if you're Big Daddy A, there are two demos, or I think Faceit only saves the last one, maybe, unless they fix that. Let me check real fast. I clicked the wrong button. Because, I mean, if you expect these same three maps to be played, you can do some very quality scouting. Oh, yeah, no, Faceit's fixed it. You can get both demos. So, I mean, IEPUI could get in those demos if needed.
Yep.
But Northwood's not going to be an easy opponent.
No, they will not. They will be favored in that matchup.
They have three players above 3K ELO. IEPUI has two, and the other two players are close to 3K ELO to an extent. So Northwood not going to be an easy team to take down for the Jaguars. But, I mean, if they can perform as well as they did on the halves that they were succeeding on, I'm thinking, you know, Overpass CT, Ancient T, and CT for that matter, as well as most of that Vertigo CT side, then IEPUI should stand at least a chance to take a map to be competitive. Because that's not a semifinal match, it can be scheduled anywhere between Friday to Monday, I believe. Once if IEPUI was to make the semifinals, those will be hard scheduled matches that will be broadcasted by Faceit. I would assume that we'll probably still do a broadcast for it, but we'll see.
If they unless if you're not at the thing, assuming they get there.
Yeah. But
what?
Any final comments?
Let's get that bread.
I can't believe that last map must have been very, very frustrating for Aiden. Every time Aiden was on the A bomb site when IEPUI was executing, like almost without fail, four kills, and his team just could not make it happen. I mean, that game was about to be 14-13 before CMX won versus Force, just starting with the Tech Knight at long range.
Yeah,
unbelievable to even think back about.
That is the problem with rosters like that. You don't have that second star or someone who can step up, and you're just kind of forced to put your star player all over the map, and then that in turn just weakens a bomb site or a location, and you're just forced to constantly make plays. And if you don't make those plays, you're just not likely to win those rounds.
Yeah. I mean, IEPUI across the three maps had a different top fragger every map. Michigan State, Aiden. So, definitely something to be said about that. Regardless, we will see you next week sometime for IEPUI versus Northwood.
Should be Monday.
Yeah, likely will be Monday. But, Northwood could force default if they wanted to.
Because one player, yeah.